Tuesday edition. The how do you say goodbye?
Apparently Jesse has no idea edition.
The we set the conversation around here. Tausch gets irritated that I'm trying to get Jordan Love on a rookie minimum salary deal. Everybody's talking about what do you do with Jordan Love edition. And the
I guess we're not going to Brazil, Tausch edition
of Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, 100.5 ESPN Madison, 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam, ESPNWisconsin.com, the ESPN app, your Alexa smart speaker, streaming live video, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and of course everything you need on WisconsinOnDemand.com and the Wisconsin On Demand app. I'm Jace Wilde in Green Bay. Jesse Nelson's in the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. From his undisclosed location, he is the Packers Hall of Famer. He's Mark Tauscher. Tausch, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing okay. You weren't going to go to Brazil anyways, right? You don't go on the road anymore unless it's like up at a strip mall up in Minneapolis. Like, you're not that interested, right?
I think where we're at. I was unlikely, doubtful. But, you know, I regret not going to London with you.
Yeah, you should have. It was fun.
Yeah, that's what I heard. Very fun. And then you adopted a soccer team, a whole cool thing. So I don't think I would have gone, but are you disappointed?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I don't fully understand. I mean, nobody wants to, you know, go on a long road trip if you don't have to, but the Packers have been very adamant about not giving up home games, right?
Indeed.
They don't want to give up home games. This wasn't a home game.
It was not.
We are a global brand. And when I say we, it's the Green Bay Packers. A global brand. We're going to end up going to Germany. There's no doubt we will play a game in Germany, and it's a great fit, obviously.
I'm going to that one.
We love drinking beers. Hopefully it's over Oktoberfest when it happens. But I just felt like if you're going to do it, it's the beginning of the season, so you'll have a buffer. You'll have that lead-up time to go to Brazil. And I think, and I don't know this, and Jason, you talked to a lot more people in the building than I do. The NFL wanted, you think the NFL wanted Green Bay to go? Of course they did. And I think the Packers pushed back, and I don't think they wanted to go. And whether or not that's how it shook out, I think it's a missed opportunity for the Packers. You're playing the day after the opening of the season.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have plenty of time to regroup. You'll have plenty of time leading in. It's a little bit of a dull period there anyways. You probably, you know, from a preseason standpoint, the team has given up. You probably would end up being more of a home game than Philadelphia because I guarantee Packer fans are looking for a reason. Oh, I've never been to Brazil. I want to go to Brazil. Oh, the Packer playing there. It's a regular season game against Jalen Hurts. Oh, baby, let's go. We'll get there early. We'll go to a soccer. We'll do all this stuff. And I think it's just, I feel like we missed the boat on this. I do.
So you think, and I don't disagree, you think that the NFL wanted the Packers to go, but the Packers were like, no, we're good. We'd rather go to Philly in November. Yes. Then go to Brazil to start the season.
I do think that's what happened, yes.
I think that's, Let's just look at it rationally.
Let's look at it rationally.
Ooh,
they announced
I didn't know we did that on this show.
All the time we do. Philadelphia has agreed to go play there. Their home game is given up. All the speculation starts, well, who does Philadelphia have that gets to come to Lincoln Financial? Oh, there's a couple of squads. Well, you're not going to do Cowboys, Giants, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
All right. That's three off the docket. So there's six teams. The NFL wants to get global. They want to get this thing to $40, $50 billion a year in revenue. Awesome. We all want that. Former players, hey, get us a little bit of that cheddar. Take good care of us as we continue to become more and more decrepit. I'm all on board. Great. Yeah. I don't know if that's what's going to happen, but whatever. So we're doing all this. And the Green Bay Packers are, you know, outside of, and you can argue this either way. There's four or five teams. Green Bay is one of them. that move the needle. And you know what even moves it more? A young ascending team with a potential star quarterback that should get $52 million a year. Those things are all in play. The NFL would have loved for it to be the Green Bay Packers and the Philadelphia Eagles. Friday night, under the lights, Brazil, Portugal, Portuguese, we'd be loving it, right? And I think that the Green Bay Packers said, nah, I don't. Because had the Packers been like, yeah, if we're called upon, we'd love to go. I don't think that's what happened. And I think now you're looking at this and you're probably saying, all right, well, Cleveland, all right.
Cleveland is very big in Brazil.
Trouble at quarterback. You signed 15 other quarterbacks. We'll take you. And the Browns fans will show up too. But I'm telling you, I just think Packer fans would have eaten this up. And if you're going to do it, opening game of the year with a nice buffer for that next week, it would have been a perfect time to do it. And it looks as if the NFL is going to move in a different direction, which is, I think it's too bad for everybody involved.
So why didn't the NFL just make them go? Is my question. If it's so good for the league and they are so popular, why doesn't Raj call up Mark and say, Mark, you're heading out, you know, into retirement. I would really love for you to enjoy everything that Brazil has to offer. We think it would be best for the league, so we don't have to send Cleveland instead. You know, we don't make you do Hard Knocks, even though that would be good for the league, for everyone to see this great
organization. Well, it's because we made the playoffs in a rebuilding year. Otherwise, I darn well sure you would have.
You're playing Mark now?
Yeah.
I didn't know we were role-playing.
Well, I just think, obviously, putting all those extra miles on isn't great. But, you know, the league is looking at this, and I just really think our fans would have loved it. Loved it. And I think the players would be excited about it too. Now, it's going to probably, I don't know the temperature patterns. Guessing it's going to be pretty hot in September over there. Probably fair, right? So
it's close to the equator, I think.
I understand why you never want to give up home games. I totally was on board with Mark on that regard.
Sure, agreed.
This is a case where I think you're probably going to, you can barter this too and say, all right, great, we'll do this, but then we're not giving up another home game for a decade. And if they say, yeah, that's fine, why would you not do it? Like, I don't get, I guess I just don't understand the whole picture. Is it that it's only been 2 years since you've done it? I could see the Packers pushing on that point. But this, to me, would have made a ton of sense. And I love the fact that this poor son of a gun, who's the guy from the Browns that leaked this? Maurice Hurst? He just unwillingly became like Adam Schefter in saying that this was happening, and now they're going to back channel and say it. But I'm guessing they'll announce it shortly. And I still am holding out hope that it's going to be the Packers. But yesterday kind of brought me to the point where I don't think that's going to be the case.
What if him leaking it causes Roger Goodell to reverse course and then decides the Packers should go, even though they'd committed to the Browns? That would all work out for you then.
Well, first off, it's not going to change my life one way or the other. I'm not going to go. I will not be going to Brazil, so it would be awesome too. But I just think it would be a ton of fun for everybody involved. That's what I think. And I see Chris and Barab saying the Eagles, wanted the Packers. Listen, Philadelphia sells out regardless. That argument from Jacksonville and Tampa and some of these other programs that don't get to see Green Bay a bunch and want that stadium full, I totally respected that. I get it. Philadelphia is going to sell out regardless. If it's Cleveland, if it's Green Bay, if it's Chicago, whoever. So that argument doesn't hold water with me in this regard. They're going to fill up.
Isn't Chris's point that it's a more competitive playoff positioning impacted game that you would want? If you're an Eagles fan or if you're the Eagles, wouldn't you rather play the Packers if it could be for a playoff position
home
than at a neutral site?
This is not – I totally agree. If I'm Philly, I'm pushing back saying I don't want Green – I want to have home field advantage versus Green Bay. I'm saying from the Packer fan standpoint and the players and the organization, you're getting rid of a road game. You're going a lot further, but I'm telling you, it at best to be 50-50 Philly-Green Bay fans in Brazil. Packer fans, I will guarantee – going to show up in a big way, like they did in London, like they will in Germany, like they do in Tampa, like they do in Vegas, like they do with the Chargers, where they do when
not
they go play out
breakfast.
West.
Not tomorrow, not after breakfast, now.
But you know that's true. And so I actually think Chris's point from Philly's standpoint is completely valid. But from a Packers standpoint, it is advantageous to take this puppy on the road, travel 6,000 miles in the heat of summer, right by the equator, and play in, is it Sao Paulo? Is it in Sao Paulo?
Yes.
It would be, I mean, yeah, it'd be for a win-win for the Green Bay Packers.
For someone whose life is completely unaffected by this, as you said, also I really enjoy the I guarantee, which I've heard, I think, 3 times now in this discussion. You seem passionate about this, even though it doesn't affect you one way or the other.
Jason, I respect the fact the NFL is doing this. They are going big. They could easily sit on their hands and keep collecting $20 billion a year, $25 billion a year. Mm-hmm. They've made it. They're trying to jam American football down the foreigners' throats, and I am all here for it.
In their homelands.
We're trying to build a base in London, and nobody said, everybody said you can't do it. I was at that game. Yeah, there were a lot of American fans there, but people were excited, and it's growing, and it's continuing to grow, and Germany is going to be a boon. Germany, remember the World League Football League where Marco and some of the guys got their career started?
Sure.
Germany was huge. People want to learn more about American football. When I did my little deal with Sky Sports, people are chomping. They're thirsty for more. And the NFL is working hard to grow it. This is a great opportunity to continue to grow it. And Brazil is a sport. I mean, they love soccer. I'm sure they'll love, you know, remember when it first started in London, everybody would just cheer the field goals. Like, that's when people got the most excited, when people would go kick extra points and field goals. Well, it's changing. People are getting more excited. So I always am looking for ways to get after the NFL, things that they don't do well, how they don't do certain things in a way. This is not one of those. This is, I think, smart business, and I feel like the Packers not going as selfishly. It's disappointing because that's another standalone big boy football game that would garner big-time attention and I think would be super fun, and I think it's advantageous for the G&G to play a pseudo-home game instead of a road game at the Link in around Thanksgiving.
Right around Jordan Love getting his extension. All right, so Jesse, and by the way, just to clarify if you joined us late, we
know. Oh, and I want to just, I just got a text from a good friend of the show, our buddy Andy North. 1 hour or 2 hour time change at most. You go over to Europe, it's 6-7 hours sometimes, depending on the daylight savings clock and everything else. You're only, the time change ain't even that big a deal. You're not looking at, so it's going to be a prime time action, Friday night, boom, boom, boom. I love the concept of it. And now that Andy texts us, I actually am even more on board. Not going to be some monster. Oh, my God, we got to, like when we went over to play in Tokyo and we got the sleep specialist telling us to sleep on planes and doing this and Michigan State doesn't. None of that. This is just what a deal for the league and for the Green Bay Packers to basically get rid of a road game, having 9.5 home games instead of 8, instead of 9. What a deal.
And the flight is only 5,376 miles from Green Bay to Sao Paulo.
So what is that, 6.5-7 hours?
Well, what is it like? New York to L.A. is what, 3,000 and change? And that's about a four-hour flight? Yeah.
Yeah, depends which bird you get, but yeah.
Great to hear from Andy North. You should schedule him to come on the show. We always enjoy his visits to our program.
Well, his Super Bowl's coming up.
That's true. Also, Jesse, are you as, again, we know that the Packers aren't going. I got a couple of tweets saying, you guys know that they leaked that the Browns are going. Yes, we know. The Tausch is making his case why I suppose the NFL should change its mind.
So, Jason and Jesse, listen, I have strong opinions. I feel strongly about this.
Yeah.
Am I crazy? What I'm saying, throw some holes at me. Why is this? Why am I wrong? Because I got some stuff yesterday. Oh, you're so mean to Jason again. And I'm just like, what? Get over it. I'm not being mean to Jason.
For the record, so, I did not think you were mean to me. I just think
you were
a sarcastic dink who thought he was funny. Say, well, he's trying to get him for the veteran minimum.
First off, I didn't say that. Somebody tweeted it, and I just repeated it.
Anytime Tausch is in the studio, he's just a little more grumpy than he usually is when he's at his undisclosed location.
Okay, don't get into that. That's not accurate at all. So throw some holes at me. Why, where am I wrong on
the
my
biggest
belief that the Packers should want to go? That they should want to go.
I don't have holes for you on that. The hole, the gaping hole in this is that it is the Philadelphia Eagles home game. And they are going to be competing with, I know they had a down year last year. They still made the playoffs, by the way, but they were
10-1. Somebody made a bold prediction that the Eagles were going to be knocked up before the rebuilding Packers last year. If you can believe somebody had that great a foresight.
Yeah, that guy, I don't know. I don't remember who that was, but that guy's rarely right otherwise, especially with trivia
questions. He didn't put any
money
on it either.
Pretty smart producer of a wildly popular radio show.
I enjoy Alex Stroph's work as well. The biggest hole is that if you're Philadelphia, you want this to be an out-of-conference game. That means the absolute least when it comes to playoff tiebreakers, okay, et cetera. That's the biggest hole. Because you want to play the Packers at home if it comes to November or December, and you're competing, jockeying for the most important number one overall seed in NFL history, you want that game at home. It's an extension of, I don't want any of my division games being played in Brazil either, right? That's what it is. So then you start to look at their schedule and the other options. I don't blame them for wanting the Packers in Philly, not because they need the tourism dollars or because, you know, Coors Light sales will be much higher while Wisconsinites are in town. It's because of the home field advantage factor. That is it. Now, I don't know if the NFL
again,
listened.
I'm not asking.
I don't know. You asked for me to poke holes. If I could finish,
that
would be great. So I don't know if the NFL asked both the Eagles and the Packers, or if they said, look, you guys get to the Eagles. Look, you guys get to choose. These are the two teams that we would like to send. We would prefer we sent the Packers because they're huge in Brazil, according to this radio show in Wisconsin. And so if I'm the Eagles and I get the opportunity to choose, I don't want the Packers in Brazil. If you're going to argue that the Packers should go, the biggest thing is your coach doesn't like the apple cart to be upset. You saw how he behaved the week of the London game.
Lessons learned from that.
The lesson he learned is don't be public with it. And don't let the team know that you don't want to do this. But he still is not going to want to do it.
No. But he should.
Operations people that would push back on you and say, that's the biggest hole on our side, which I was trying to get to, is that we want it to be as simple as possible.
Yeah, well, that's not life. That's not how life works.
Yeah, but you remember when you were playing. You remember how coaches are. Mike Sherman and Mike McCarthy are both this way. They don't want anything that throws off the rhythm of the season.
But you know what? It also throws off the rhythm for the Philadelphia Eagles and a home game. I get what you're saying from Philly's standpoint. I don't care about Philly. I don't care nothing about Philly. Okay? What I care about is the Green Bay Packers and what is going to give them the best opportunity. This is if indeed it is the Packers that said no, which I don't know for sure. All I know is the league would love for the Green Bay Packers to do it. Maybe Philly came down with their big old veto pen and said, no, sir. No, sir. We're not doing that because it's a conference game and all the stuff that you just went through. And if that's the case, all right, I get it. The league's got to try to have as competitive a balance. But if Philly didn't care and the Packers were the ones that said we don't want to do it, I don't fully understand why outside of I don't like long airplane rides. That's the only reason. Otherwise, home game instead of a roadie, early season exposure, build that brand up, make that cat, make the, I don't know exactly I should know this, being a three-semester Portuguese student. Yeah. I don't know what the dollar is in Brazil, but make them whatever's their currency is over there. And have a great time with a great experience bringing your team together for a roadie before the season even starts. That's powerful. All positive things for the G&G. And now it doesn't look like that's going to be the case.
I believe it's the Real in Brazil.
Nope, that doesn't ring a bell. That's not what I remember it as. Not to say you're wrong. I'm just telling you I don't remember it. Now, again, part of the trick is part of learned Portuguese.
Why did I get the buzzer based on what Tausch said?
He didn't think it was right.
So part of the problem when I learned Portuguese back in college was
that you didn't
there's
listen.
Continental. No, there's continental, and then there's the Brazilian form. So there's actually two different dialects that come with learning Portuguese.
Sure. The Brazilian real
I'm
is the
sure
official
where Steve
currency.
Butterby. Steve,
of
what
Brazil.
Is the real?
It is subdivided into 100 centavos. Does that ring a bell of any
that's
sort?
Cents. Yeah, that's cents, which would be our cents.
Wow.
Thanks for explaining
need to
that.
Study at the
Joe
next
Barry.
Level to figure that one out.
I don't want to get all. I don't want to be all uppity because I know another language and you guys don't, but. Centavos would be, in essence,
do you really know another language?
It's best right there.
Eu sou ele, no somos ele siao. I can tell you that.
If you would do the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin read right here in Portuguese, I will believe that you know two languages.
I don't think. Listen, if I could, I would. I can't, and I know Gina doesn't want to because it's important that I get this point across to y'all. If you've been waiting to replace broken windows and doors, or if you just want to revitalize your home with a new look, now is the time to get it done and to go over to Brazil to play the Eagles. Because from now until March 31st, you can get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's right. Pella now and pay later. 3 years later, in fact. Order by March 31st. Get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
Janelas e portas Pella de Wisconsin. Janelas e portas Pella de Wisconsin.
That would be Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin in Portuguese.
That's pretty good.
Thank you. Google Translator really deserves all the credit there. We will continue to debate something that's apparently already been decided, and that the Packers are not going to Brazil. We'll also talk more about what they've got going on in their offensive line, about giving Jordan Love as much money as possible as soon as humanly possible, and our friend Tom Wilson leaving ESPN Madison. That's all still ahead. Stick around. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
You're back at the gym. Your new gym outfit? On point. Your new sneakers? Baller. You've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with Access Checking. It's maintenance fee free with no minimum balance requirements. So when you take your first yoga class in 10 months, your body might surprise you, but your checking account won't. You've got this with Access Checking from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
ESPN Madison is on Wisconsin sports. Catch up on anything you missed on the Varsity Podcast on Wisconsin On Demand. Brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of Wisconsin Badger Athletics. If you're looking to purchase, finance, or service a new or pre-owned Honda, stop local. Part of the Madison community since 1973.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families. to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Hi, this is Lee, inviting you to Ruth's Chris Steakhouse in Middleton. We got a great happy hour every day of the week from 4 o'clock to 7, and our patio during the summer is open too. If you're getting married, special occasion, a birthday, anniversary, or even a business meeting, we've got all the accommodations right here at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. You work hard, and sometimes you're not sure what you want to do, where you want to spend your money. I want to encourage you to come into Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and say hello. It'd be a pleasure to meet you.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
We're on the tournament.
I think I'm ready to say the Badgers are fully back.
Because we are on Wisconsin Sports.
You want to be playing your best ball in March, and Greg Gard has this group doing just that.
This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
It's a beautiful day. Sky falls, you feel like it's a beautiful day. To let it get away on the road.
Jesse, how much feedback are we getting on the text portion of the Talk and Text line about this debate? Has anyone poked holes in Tausch's, the Packers should be thrilled if they were offered the opportunity to go to Brazil and should have taken it?
So I've got one here from Dave in Verona that just came in, so I'm not going to have time to flash it up on the screen for you, but I'll show me while I read it.
How is that an upgrade?
Hey, everybody. Packers believe they are in a Super Bowl run. Minimizing the distractions and keeping them focused is more important to Green Bay than growing the NFL brand. From Dave in Verona. That's the best effort so far to try and poke a hole in what you're saying, Tausch. That the Packers' reasoning for not wanting to go is they want to keep things as basic as they can, as normal as they can, because they're trying to win a Super Bowl. They're not worried about the fanfare of the National Football League.
Yeah, I mean, I get it that they shouldn't be focused on that part of it, but the league as a whole ask you to do some things sometimes you don't want to do. That's just how it goes. And in this case, it would be great to have 17 home games too. That's not how it is. Well, I don't want to have to go here. Well, my point is, yes, it's a long flight. And Clinkster said it's like a 14-hour flight, so I don't
from
know
Winnipeg?
If that's accurate. I didn't ask. I just saw he was tweeting. I think it's probably about a 10-hour direct flight. They're not going to be – you know, they're not going to connect through Chicago and then Lima, Peru, and then jump down there. I think they're going to probably have a big old big boy plane and go the whole way. So that's the part of it that I can understand, you pushing back. But the positives are so much better than the negatives in this case because of all of the points that I already illustrated. The big one is you get to bond as a team in a really cool spot, and you take away a home game from a team that's probably going to be nipping at your heels when it becomes, you know, December, and you can get a chance to win a game that's not even a road game, and your fans going to go have a great time down in Brazil. All of those things are awesome, in my opinion.
According to United Airlines, a nonstop flight from O'Hare to Sao Paulo, 10 hours, 15 minutes.
It's child's play. It's awesome. Have a great time. Oppenheimer. You can watch Dynasty, the Patriots thing. This new show that I'm really excited to start that my hockey fellas got me onto, Stanicky. Stanicky is the name of the show. So there's all kinds of fun things you can watch. You can play cards on the plane. It's going to be awesome. So 10 hours is child's play. I mean, you go from Seattle to London, it's the same blanking flight, man. That's probably 10 hours. So I'm not concerned. And you get to get out there early. You have a three-day buffer before you get back to week two with the Friday game, and it's you know a little earlier, and you're back Saturday. You get a couple days, you get back to your Tuesday deal, and boom, off we go.
Ricky Stanicky?
Yeah.
Ricky Stanicky with Zac Efron and John Cena.
That's a movie. That's not a...
That is a feature film.
Well, no, I'm excited to watch it. I've heard nothing but great things. As a matter of fact...
Right after Oppenheimer.
I have not watched it, but I've been told enough that I kind of understand it, and I believe I want to make up my own Ricky Stanicky. Like, I want to come up with my own Ricky Stanicky that's going to be a part of this show. That's what I think I'm going to end up doing.
And it'll be a murder mystery.
How can you say that if you haven't even seen the movie yet?
I've heard enough. These guys talk about it ad nauseum. So I've heard enough. And I've, again, got a little trip coming up here, and I wanted to start banking things. I banked Oppenheimer. I wanted to watch Oppenheimer out to Washington State back in September. Well, they never put it on the blanket plane. They waited until, February to do it. So here we go. Now I'm sitting here on backlog. I got all these things. I got a book I got to finish. I got all kinds of stuff that I got to get going to.
But you're going to let Ricky Stanicky fast pass to the front of the line after all that?
Yeah, I think. Ricky Stanicky will be in play. I feel very
It's got a 6.2 on Rotten Tomatoes. You're going to put it in front of the movie of the year, Best Picture from the Oscars?
Oppenheimer is first in the queue. Then I really want to get to Dynasty, the Dynasty movie. And then I want to get to Full Swing,
Dynasty's
which has also been raved
documentary.
About.
Dynasty.
And then I see, you know, they did the quarterbacks with Cousins and all this. They're doing one, unfortunately for me, it's not going to be available, but Davante Adams, Justin Jefferson, receiver it's called, which to me is more interesting than quarterbacks because those cats are going to be open and honest and let it rip. So there's just – it's a situation overload for old T when it comes to all this stuff.
And you'd already have Oppenheimer checked off the list if you had just caved and gotten Peacock to watch the Badgers.
We all watched it the same night. You didn't. Missed out.
And I didn't pay for it. I don't know how you managed to miss the opportunity for it. All right. Well, as much as I could talk about not going to Brazil all day, we did drive the conversation across ESPN Wisconsin yesterday, much to Dennis and Plover's chagrin because we disagreed, but this
chagrin's a fun word.
It is a fun word, isn't it? You know what's even more fun? Picturing you in your concrete hip waders and your butt crack working on your internship at Johnson & Sons Paving.
Yeah, I'm excited, and if you want to see old T, I don't know if that's what I'll be doing. We got a picture up around paving, and I'm putting pavers in. I got different things, tie rod and stuff that you're going to put in to make that concrete.
Tie Rod Taylor?
Old T is going to be out at one of the sites. We got to go to JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com now. You got to start planning. It's not easy to just, boom, snap your fingers and get some paving done. Now is the time to set those preferred dates for booking Johnson & Sons Paving. Whether it's asphalt or concrete, they set the standard. Maybe you need patching now, but you'll want a full repave later. Well, talk with a project manager. Set yourself up with a five-year game plan. And with two civil engineers on staff and a team with decades of experience, they have seen it all. Booking Work Now will give you all the time to get all of that paperwork in place. And again, you want to get old T out there shoveling concrete, troweling, throwing up forms, doing all that stuff. Go to JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com. Going to get out there. I'm not sure if I'm going to get Jesse with me. I'm going to try. He's going to come out there and get some work in, too. Get those little baby hands. Get some calluses on there. Get to work with JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com.
Baby hands?
Yeah, what's the last, like, physical labor that you've done?
You know, that
your hands have calloused. Just curious.
Are your hands currently calloused?
Yeah. Yeah, I've been doing some deadlifting and
big
some hand
deadlifter.
Cleans where... Just moving the bar and stuff, you get your hands a little callousy, yeah.
I thought you wore, like, weightlifting gloves.
I don't. No. I don't know why you would think that. I don't.
I don't know. No. Protect your baby hands. Because you're doing a lot of manual labor, from what I understand. I thought maybe the calluses were
I will
were
be
pickleball.
Doing a lot of labor. How
many shifts are you going to put in with them?
I'm going to do one shift. Well, listen, there's a lot of people that work at Johnson & Sons Paving. I'm not going to go in there and steal 15 shifts. I'm going to go in and help out.
Steal 15 shifts.
What if you're really good at
it? For half a day. Oh, I'll be really good at it. I've got 5-6 years of experience, Jesse. I've done this years
ago. Sometime
in
the
90s. I did. Yeah. Had to retire before the millennium. I was worried about Y2K, so I said, sure. I can't do any more shoveling.
You're gonna call Johnson & Sons the morning of your shift. You're like, sorry, I'm still watching Ricky Stenicki. I can't make it in today.
You'll be the Ricky Stenicki of Johnson & Sons Paving. All right, I want to get to this Jordan Love discussion. We'll do that next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
We tend not to think about right now, but right now in front of us is victory over cancer. Right now, cancer research funded by the V Foundation is leading to better treatments and saving lives. When you give to the V Foundation, 100% of your donation goes directly to game-changing cancer research. Victory over cancer is there for the taking by you. Donate at V.org because today's cancer research is tomorrow's victory.
Don't give up. Don't ever give up.
Is your computer so slow you can hardly use it? Does it have blue screens, malware, viruses, reboots, hardware crashes? Sound familiar? Computers will have problems, and when they do, you need the computer experts at Madison Computer Works. Every day, we help home users and businesses keep their computers and networks running smoothly. For solutions to your computer problems, call the pros at 231-8000, and we'll turn this into this. Madison Computer Works, computers that work for you.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers. the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
Hey, hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings, next level super wings, with trusty sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender, quick chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded, down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip, saving your nuggets from ordinary.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about needs, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
As much as I enjoyed our back and forth yesterday, which I thought was in fine spirit.
Sure. I agree.
I didn't think it was contentious. Again, I've explained this. I feel like we're at a point with Jordan Love where if you don't just want to push every penny of free money that we have at him, you're somehow anti-Jordan. Well, I'm telling you the feedback I got. How can you not want to pay him?
No. So this is why I put the number where I did. And I know Jesse and I had a good discussion post-show yesterday. I understand, you know, kind of where your head's at. I know you don't want to be because you overboardedly say, I like Jordan Love. I mean, I don't know.
No, I genuinely like him.
I know you do, but I'm saying you literally say it seven times a show minimum. Mm-hmm. If I prize picks project, I'd set it at 5.5, and I would go more every day because I can set you up to make you have to say that. I'm not going to do that.
But I'll be cheating.
The point I was trying to have, and it wasn't about, well, 54 to 52. It was about how much do you believe in Jordan Love, and was that just a rookie whim, or is he going to have a sophomore slump? Do you believe he's going to be the cat moving forward? And I did not say pay him 60 like was what Dak Prescott wants. I have not went there. The question I had, this is not about how much money he should get. It's about, do you believe that this is where he fits in the pantheon of quarterbacking? And my point was that through the last 10 weeks of that season, there ain't anybody better. Nobody played better than he did the last 10 weeks of the year. Does that mean he's going to play that awesome moving forward? And by the way, the NFL teams mitigate risk. That's what good businesses do. So your point on, well, I would like to just get him at like $44 million a year.
That's not what
I said. Yeah, that's great, Jason. In essence, that's what you said. And that is what the Packers will hope for. Uh-huh. And I think the point that you bring up will be interesting is, how much guaranteed money is Jordan Love going to pass on? If it's at $46.5 million a year and he gets $120 up front, that's a lot to pass on. But does Jordan Love want to be the guy where it's, I want to be the highest paid cat like David Bakhtiari wanted to be? Those are the interesting battle lines. But this is a referendum on Jordan Love, the belief you have after his fourth season. To me, it is very high. I've seen him work through things and the way he carries himself, the way his teammates respond to him. And, by the way, the biggest question I had, which is accuracy, I don't have those same questions anymore. Now, that doesn't mean he is going to go to Brazil and have a stinker of a game, and everybody's going to be
freaking
out.
We understand,
but if that is the case, I'm not going to panic like maybe we started panicking in October of last year, because we've now seen enough to know he has this in him. And David on Friday, I thought, had great quotes about raising the floor, and he hasn't even cracked the ceiling as far as where he can be. That should be exciting to Packer fans. And by the way, that is worth $52.5 million all day, every day. If he hasn't even if what we saw the last 10 weeks isn't his ceiling, good luck to the rest of y'all chasing the G&G.
So are you suggesting that he is going to be better than the people that are paid more than $50 million right now? Or is it more rising tide is he's the next guy, so that's why? Because Lamar Jackson just won his second NFL MVP. His year per average is $52 million. Now, yep. I'm not saying that Jordan Love's not capable of doing what Lamar Jackson has done, but Lamar Jackson had one MVP when he got that contract. Jordan Love has 9 games of really, really good football. That's what he has on his resume.
10. I'd argue 10, but and Jason, if I'm the Packers, I'm talking just like you are. I'm saying that what I don't want to see happen, and I do not think this is, because I was thinking about this after our discussion yesterday. Is there anyone in the Packers organization you trust more than Russ Ball to do his job at a high level?
Well, I mean, Jordan Love, apparently, because that's who we're going to pay $52 million.
Russ has done this for 10 years. Is there anybody in the Packers organization you trust to do what their job is more than Russ Ball?
Probably not.
No. So Russ is going to get it done. He's going to do it the right way, and he's probably going to push hard to not pay the 52.5. But do I think that he deserves to be paid as high as Patrick Mahomes and Joey Burrow and Lamar Jackson? His resume doesn't prove that. But you know what? That's not what the NFL is about. It's not about what you've done. It's about what you believe they'll do. And the Green Bay Packers, the salary cap went up how much this year, Jason?
$30 million.
$31 million? 30 more. What do you think it's going to do next year? Is it going to go down?
I don't think it's going to go down.
Could there be another pandemic?
No.
Could there be other stuff? Of course, there could be. But that will be protected. It's going to go up. So why would Jordan Love look at it and say, well, I'll take the same thing that old boy took 3 years ago when the cap was at $220 million? Like, that's just not how it works, and that's why I thought that number was so pristine to force your hand, or our hand, or fans' hands, into making those decisions. And you didn't want to do that for a couple of reasons, and I'm all right with that. But I like having the conversation because, and I saw Jen, Gabe, and Chewy's poll, which was better than what I could have come up with.
Which is what
because
I'm going
I
to do
love
next.
The movie. I love the movie Rounders. Love it. I have seen it a bunch of times.
Pay that man his money.
And in fairness, what I wanted to get, instead of putting a number on it and making you uncomfortable, I shouldn't have done that.
I wasn't
what I should
uncomfortable.
Have done, it's not what Dennis and some other people have said. So I think when I look back at it, I would rather, I should have stolen this from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
Before they did
it. I like the fact that you're putting, yes, preemptive stealing, P.S. If you put the pay that man his money or... what was the other part? Let
always
it ride.
Leave
or
yourself
the...
withouts, Mike McDermott.
And I think you should always, as the Packers, you should always leave yourself withouts. You should. So maybe that was a better way to put this whole thing in a bow.
Mm.
But the bottom line, what I don't want to see happen is contention. And I don't want to see what the Dallas Cowboys are dealing with right now with Dak Prescott. That is the worst case scenario for the G&G. Where you're constantly chasing, and instead of just doing what Patrick Mahomes and Joe Burrow, because this way you've shown your allegiance to this young man, you've said you are our guy, where the Cowboys reluctantly pulling their fingernails through the door. Okay, fine, we have to, so we will. And now Dak's like, well, blank you. I could redo a deal, but blank off. You're forcing my hand. I'm going to get every last penny from you. Kansas City's not doing that. I'm guessing Joe Burrow won't do it because now they feel vested with the group. Dak feels like a mercenary. Like, they won't pay me till they had to. I don't want that to happen. And in Russ Ball, we trust because Russ Ball has been a magician with what he's done. And there is nobody up in Green Bay that I think you feel better about getting their job done at a high level than Russ Ball.
Yeah, I do think it's important to point out that Dak Prescott is going into his third contract. He already got a four-year, $160 million contract 4 years ago. So his situation is different.
It is, but Jason, but it's not because it's kind of similar. The Cowboys could have paid him the going rate, which was a little bit more than Aaron Rodgers, or would have been even a little bit less than Aaron Rodgers. They didn't want to. They franchised him. They never wanted to go where I believe Jordan Love's team is going to want them to go. And instead of going there and not paid that man his money, even though you think at the time it's, wow, you can't pay him more than Lamar Jackson. Well, you're going to end up having to pay him more, and you're going to have to do it with pulling those fingernails through and yanking, screaming, itching, all that. And instead, you could look at it and say, yeah, 52 is a lot a year, but you know what? The cap's going to be $320 million, and it won't be that bad. And now we'll have you for 4 or 5 years, and then we can renegotiate, and we can tinker with you, and we can do this. Dak never – they never have done that with Dak because they forced Dak's hand – scratching and clawing to get every penny, and I don't want to see that happen. I don't believe it will, but I'm telling you, if it is sitting there and you say, well, we're only going to pay you $44 million, if I'm Jordan Love's team, I'm saying, no, cap's going up. It's got to be – if you're not going to start with a 5 and a 2, I'm not interested.
With a 5 and a 2. The cap this year is $255.4 million. The cap next year, I feel fairly confident, will not be $320 million. It will go up, to be sure. I don't really like the imagery of the fingernail pulling.
Get what I'm saying, though?
I get it. I don't enjoy the imagery. So,
Give me a better image. I'm fine. I'm open to better images.
Would you rather drink a cold Blue Mountain Coors Light or some skunky beer that's still warm, it's been sitting out in the sun while you've been paving, and that's all you get to choose from?
Oh, there's nothing better than paving hot asphalt on a warm June day, which, again, you can do, and then you get done and you sit back with your boys and you crack open a Coors Light in your chair just sitting back and saying, what a day's work. Coors Light brewed with a 3-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and cold packaged, so it is made to chill. Born in the Rocky Mountains of Colorado in 1978, Coors Light's refreshing. It's crisp. It's only 102 calories. That's why after a long, hard day of paving, a little bit of golf, whatever it might be, Coors Light is in my hand when I want to chill. Celebrate responsibly. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Jesse, if you're really on it, next time we do that, the Coors Light raid within Johnson & Sons paving and everything else, another great Shawshank line. When Andrew Dufresne got beers for his boys, tarring the roof up top, probably should have called Johnson & Sons Paving, would have gotten it done at a better price and everything else, but that would be the next thing I'd like to see you start.
In like 1936 or whenever that film is set?
Try to tie it all together. Yeah, tying it all together.
Yeah, you definitely are. We're going to play a little Did You Hear This from David Bakhtiari later in the show. I want to talk about Jen, Gabe, and Chewy's poll question and let you know what the results are so far as we get ready for the 10 o'clock hour, which will include the Badgers Outsider. That all still ahead. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And who do we have coming up in today's podcast?
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Stay tuned for info. Tickets are on sale soon. Thanalysis, live in Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
You, rah-rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to BadgerlandChevy.com. For the 15th time in program history, the Wisconsin women's hockey team is headed to the Frozen Four. With a 4-0 win over St. Lawrence at LeBron on Saturday, the reigning national champion Badgers have the opportunity to defend their crown this weekend in Durham, New Hampshire. Wisconsin will face off with Colgate in the Frozen Four, with the winner headed to the national championship game on Sunday. Clarkson and conference foe Ohio State will face off in the other semifinal. Puck drop between Colgate and Wisconsin set for 6:30 this Friday on ESPN+.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
Zimbrick Chevrolet.
When was the last time you had your oil changed or your tires rotated? Do you need new tires, a battery, perhaps some windshield wipers? Zimbrick Chevrolet's service center is equipped to help you with routine maintenance, major repairs, and everything in between. Get your free battery inspection coupon and schedule an appointment today at ZimbrickChevrolet.com. Don't overpay. Shop Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie.
Main Street, Sun Prairie, Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Whether you're an artist playing accountant, a barista trying to be a bean counter, or a student just looking to get started, the UW Credit Union app lets you be free to be you. With free credit scores, free online bill pay, and the ability to send money to friends. Because with fewer fees, you can do more of what you love. UW Credit Union, here for every you. Join today at uwcu.org. Federally insured by NCUA.
Life's better with American Family Insurance, because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Getting up to 5% back is easy at Fleet Farm. Fleet Rewards members can earn up to 5% back on every purchase, in-store and online. The earnings stack up automatically. The more you buy, the more you earn. No rebates, no coupons, no hassles. And Fleet Rewards membership is easy, so sign up now and start earning up to 5% back on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. Some exclusions apply.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
The poll question, as posed by Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, which you can listen to every weekday from 7 to 9 on 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, currently stands at this. And again, if you missed Tausch's imitation of Teddy KGB, played by John Malkovich, which quote from the classic 1997 film Rounders would you... Now they're capitalizing you. They're stealing our shtick.
They are not.
They are.
They
would. You...
Oh, man.
I think I've influenced Joshy DiMaggio a little bit there. Would you use to describe how the Packers should handle Jordan Love's contract extension? Teddy KGB saying...
Pay that man his monies.
Or Mike McDermott saying, always leave yourself with outs. I retweeted it. We're up to 352 votes on it. Pay that man his money. That's 66%.
Pay that man his monies. Not that. Pay that man his monies. Yeah, you got to pay him. Got him.
66%. Leave yourself some outs. 34%. So.
What do you think of the hashtag? And I didn't do it. Because I didn't feel great about it. In Russ, we trust.
Let Russ cook, I would prefer. cook the books.
Didn't you try to do a trust a couple of years ago or
big
something?
Big trust. Yeah, it was big trust. But, yeah, it didn't work. But
I don't like it.
My point on this whole thing, to put a bow on this.
Red Batty. One of the first response to you is Red Batty. In terms of people that you trust more to do their job.
No, I'd go Russ over Red. Russ just, he has gotten the job done at an incredibly high level. And even with these guys that they just brought in, there's outs. He is, what's the guy's name? Mike McDermott? I don't think that, is that his name in the movie?
Yes.
Mike McDermott, he is the Mike McDermott. And by the way, that's a steadier, nicer way to live, but you don't ride the wave like Matt Damon and like what's his buddy's name in there? Scar. What's
sounds like you have to watch this movie on your next trip.
Scar. This isn't the Lion.
What is his name? What's the dude's name?
As played, you're talking about Edward Norton's his character.
Ed Norton. Yes.
Let me check that for you. I don't remember. I remember there's a guy that goes by Grandma.
I've never seen the movie.
That's not Grandma. I've seen the movie. You've never seen Rounders?
Ugh. Jesse, how old were you in 1997?
Six.
Well, how old are you now?
32.
There you go. I had 26 years to watch it. What are you doing?
Come on. Worm. Worm is
Wormy.
His
Wormy.
His name.
I've heard of his called Scar before too, but Wormy.
I've heard it both ways.
Scar. John Turturro, very good in that film. All right. Again, I don't have any problem paying Jordan Love his money. I don't think the 10 games or 9 games or 9.5 games or whatever we're going with is enough of a body of work to say, let's pay him the same amount as a guy who's won two MVPs. And I don't care that
it's a fair
rising
point.
The cost is going up and the cap is going up. I'm not saying he can't get, and again, the guaranteed money is what really matters here, right? Like the rest
Correct.
Of it is positioning by agents to say, I got the richest contract for any quarterback, yep. But how much of it are you guaranteeing? Because if we're being
exactly.
honest, the guy who's got the best contract is the guy that grosses me out. And that's Deshaun Watson. Because the Cleveland Browns guarantee
going to
every
Brazil
single
too.
Penny and of his contract.
And they get to go to Brazil. And that's where Lamar Jackson fought to get it. He was unable to. Jordan Love will not get it. Kirk Cousins even didn't get a fully guaranteed contract, but he still did really well. All I'm saying is, and I do not think this is going to happen, but what I don't want to have happen is the Dak Prescott experiment. I don't want the DPE to come to the GB. That's it. I do not want to see toenails being clawed and pulled to force me to pay him, and then, oh, God,
toenails.
I got to do this and this and this and this. I don't, and that will not happen.
But look at how that's working with Dallas. Now, he's going to be a $60 million cap hit this year, and they can't sign anybody else, and they got one running back that they're paying the minimum to. That is the scenario that Russ Ball has steered clear of, and he will again. But that's what I'm concerned about if you're a Packer fan. Until that contract is signed, I don't want us to be playing a bunch of chicken, and then we end up getting our toenails plucked.
Just for accuracy's sake, they reworked his contract yesterday, and now his cap number is down to $55 million for this year.
But that wasn't his doing. That was automatically they were able to do that. That wasn't Dak doing him a solid. That was the Cowboys doing what was within their rights CBA-wise.
And they are negotiating an extension, right?
I just heard Adam Schefter on Unsportsmanlike say no. There has not been much and then his question was, and I know we got to go to break, his question was, if you're going to do a new deal with him, do it before the new league year so that you have some cap space to maybe bring in a couple free agents and not let Tyron Smith walk for six. And that is where the DPE does not need to be in the GB. Don't want any part of it. Okay?
Proud of
the
that one, huh?
DPE.
Pretty good. It rhymes.
Need to go to it twice.
Well, I didn't get the reaction I was looking for from you guys, so I thought I'd go to it again.
It's pretty good.
Can you give us the KS Reed in the GB and the MKE?
Oh,
and
you
the
know
MSN?
That's right. You know that's right. I've seen a lot of bad bathrooms over the course of the last couple months. I got the one down in Dallas that is
heard some bad acronyms too.
God awful. We had that other one where there's three toilets lined up right next to each other. I don't know what the hell they were doing. And if you need a bath or shower remodel, don't go to those cats. Turn to Kohler Services, a family-owned business. 150 years, Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. And this month only, get $1,000 off. Not $500, not $750. You get $1,000
now.
Get $1,000 off your Luxtone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional, no butt cracks, fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
How many references did you just get in that one read?
Hey, I'm on fire today, baby. I am on fire today.
At what point does Teddy KGB say nothing? You get nothing. I don't remember that part of the film. Maybe that's
I don't
the
remember,
sequel.
But it was part of it. Jesse, you remember where that was?
I didn't see it.
The 10 o'clock hour, which will include a visit from the Badgers outsider if he can get up the elevator, is straight ahead. Stick around.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years. Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. This month only, get $1,000 off your Luxtone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
This is former Wisconsin linebacker Chris Orr. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN, WTLX, Monona, Madison, a Good Karma Brands radio station on Wisconsin.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out, 220 State Street and online at goodmansjewelers.com. The countdown is on to tip-off of the NCAA tournament. The first four begins tonight. The first round begins Thursday. Wisconsin and Marquette play Friday. Both teams favored in their matchups. Wisconsin a 5 seed against 12 seed James Madison. First meeting in each program's history against one another. Wisconsin listed as a 5.5-point favorite, according to ESPN Bet, despite the popularity of James Madison in the 12-5 upset. Meanwhile, Marquette 2-seed, 14-point favorite, according to ESPN Bet, against 15-seed Western Kentucky, 1 o'clock Friday afternoon in Indianapolis. ESPN bracketologist Joe Lenardi outlines what he projects for both Wisconsin and Marquette and every team in the tournament. Check it out over at ESPNWisconsin.com. That's also where you can sign up for the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge, your chance to win a $1,000 Cousin Subs gift card. The Bucks off until tomorrow night when they have a huge game visiting the Boston Celtics. Tip time tomorrow set for 6:30.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Clock hour of Wilde and Tausch begins now. It will include a visit from the Badgers outsider. Is this his farewell visit for the year?
No, I think we'll keep him coming around as long as Wisconsin's in it or until they lose, I think.
As long as they make the Sweet 16, which is really what matters.
What if they won the conference tournament?
Well, then we'd have him every week all summer long because we'd be celebrating that more, according to your brothers.
Let's go to yesterday's poll questions, shall we?
Might as well call it a national title. Times three.
Yesterday's poll question was this. As inspired by Pat and Helmut and OT and OLT debating, which matters more on Greg Gard's resume as the head coach of the Badgers? Winning the Big Ten tournament or reaching the Sweet 16 of the NCAA tournament. I'm kind of disappointed that there's two words fully capitalized, all caps in here, but none of them is you, because that's usually our format. Reaching the Sweet 16, 81.1%. Winning the Big Ten tourney, 18.9%.
Yeah.
81-19 beatdown.
That's a beating. Again, I still think when Greg Gard decides to retire, either willingly or unwillingly, I would bet that you'll say, Gardo, two, hopefully three conference championships, a conference tournament championship, and
a national title.
16 appearances. Hopefully a national championship would be the
final
lead.
Four of this year, but from what I hear.
I'm telling you right now, in the pantheon of ranking and tiering things, you're going to tier conference championship ahead of a Sweet 16. You just will. Final Four would be ahead of a conference championship. That's how this works. And I don't think anyone that's going to sit here and argue now, what the tournament is everything. It is. But you got to win the dang thing. It's not just good enough to get to the second weekend. That's my point.
Yeah, I think what we're talking about here is the difference between what matters more in real time and what matters more when you look back on the length of your career and your accomplishments after it's over. Because nobody is very excited. Had they won the Big Ten Conference tournament, that would have been great, and you would have been impressed, and it would have been cause for celebration. But if you lose the following weekend with your opening round game against James Madison, which I noticed Seth Davis on the selection show not only picked James Madison to beat the Badgers, but to also beat his own alma mater, Duke, and reach the Sweet 16. Again,
in fairness, he knows nothing more than we do.
If that were to occur, no one is sitting here going, God, that was great, though, that they won the Big Ten Conference tournament in Minneapolis.
Oh, they
Everyone's
will when
pissed
he's done.
That they lost. Right.
Yeah, for
but
sure.
They're pissed that he
but
lost
he will when it's done.
Next week on Friday.
Sure, I agree. How am I going to argue that? It's too good of a point. I can't.
That's for you, Dennis and Clover.
Will people celebrate? If they lose to Houston in the Sweet 16, would people celebrate? Oh, they beat Duke. They beat James Madison. Or would that just be kind of like,
no, Tosh will celebrate beating Duke.
No, for that week, we will. But, yeah, then it'll be, we'll say, nice season. Sweet 16, nice season. Not great,
But you add a conference championship in or a conference tournament, that sweetens it a little bit. It's a sweetener. Well, is it not a sweetener?
It is. But, again, I think it's about the real time. And if they lose a close game to the number one seed, and that's what ends their season, that's a little more palatable, right? You lose to James Madison, and no one gives a damn what you did in Minnesota. They just don't. They don't. They're mad that you lost in the first round of the NCAA tournament. That's how fans are going to react. And I don't have any problem with feeling that way. All right, we need to get to the Badgers Outsider. We'll ask him about that.
Is there an Abraham Lincoln University? I think most people look at him as the GOAT when it comes. We have George Washington University, James Madison University. Is there an Abraham Lincoln University? I know there's Lincoln, Nebraska. But is there an Abe Lincoln University?
It's a law school in Glendale, California.
Okay, how's their basketball team?
Well, I don't know, but their debate team's probably pretty good.
William Howard Taft University.
Stout. That'd be a stout squad.
Yeah, it sure would.
Okay.
Jason, if I had you listed, I gave you 5 minutes.
Grover Cleveland.
How many presidents
State.
Could you name? I would like to do a digi only. You get a little lead time here because we did this weekend too. While I wasn't winning dice games and Euchre championships, we did the president's deal. And there's, 46 presidents or is it 47 because Cleveland was twice? How many are you naming in the course of a commercial break?
I don't know. I'm naming Derek Blakeslee as the president of the Badgers Outsider Fan Club and the treasurer of the Derek Blakeslee Reedsburg Hall of Fame Committee. We need to get to him as much as I'd like to
name
him.
You could make a guess on what you would say.
No, I'm going to set it at 38. My prize picks projection's 38. So, Jason, Jesse, can we do this? We're putting Jason on the spot. But over the course of a 4.5-minute break, you just write down, go. How many presidents are you naming in a commercial break?
We'll have to do it later because I have to get Blakeslee all set up here. We can't do it right now.
Why? No, Jason can just do it, right? No?
Gruberloff says, one call, that's all. If you've been injured in an accident and you need legal representation, all it takes is one call to David and his team. 414-276-6666. 414-276. What has gotten into you today? 6666. Or
I mean,
go
I'm having
online.
Fun and laughing? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what's gotten into me.
Good Abraham experience. Lincoln University. That's where I don't know. Maybe that's where David got his law degree from. Gruber Law Offices, gruber-law.com. Find out more about the firm, all the great lawyers that are there, David's history in our community, and all the community involvement that the firm has. Gruber-law.com. Our Badgers outsider, Derek Blakeslee, joins us next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood near you. Serving lunch and dinner 7 days a week with brunch every Saturday and Sunday. I'll see you at Buck and Honey's.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy.
We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
What does it take to make a diamond? Extreme heat and pressure and about a billion years. But you can't wait that long. What do? You go to Goodman's Jewelers. I'm John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. There's a reason we are the Diamond Store of Madison. Since 1933, we've provided outstanding service and selection to our customers. And that in turn has helped to establish countless great memories through the years. Goodman'sJewelers.com, located at 220 State Street. Truly a destination worth reaching.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you last minute Lisa, we'll make your last minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
The time has come. You know, we say that the league comes at you fast in the NFL, but I feel like the last time we talked to Derek Blakeslee, it was how things were spiraling for the Badger men's basketball team. And now they played in a conference tournament championship game, and they're a five seed.
Great ball.
Yep. They look like they've found themselves again, and we find Derek Blakeslee joining us, the Badgers outsider, presented by PDS.
Indeed, PDS has been providing technology solutions, and they've transformed IT for area companies for over 30 years. PDS is giving today's worker the true ability to work from anywhere as they balance work and life. PDS wants to be your trusted partner in driving success with enterprise solutions, digital workplace platforms, and managed services that fit your needs. PDS, Paragon Development Systems.
Good morning, Mr. Blakeslee, going up. How you doing?
Speaking of going up, how about those Badgers?
Not your best.
Well,
not your best. Not your worst.
Hey, I'm just here trying to have a great time. You guys are all taking
definitely not your worst.
Seriously. It's good to be here. I had a nice clean ride up. Hunter came down and got me today, and he was timely and efficient. But every single time an employee of this operation brings out the swiper to get up to this floor on the elevator, and I stand there like an idiot, a half a decade in, no way to access. Like I am some kind of security threat. Almost like Connor Assisian used to be a three-point threat.
Wait, are you asking for that?
I have.
I don't have a card.
You never come to work. I mean, everybody knows that. I'm the only one that actually takes this.
I was just there on Friday.
And don't think I didn't see that.
First time in a year and a half, though. Yeah. First time in 18 months.
Not in a year and a half. That's not true.
No, but you guys are pros. I come in because I really have to concentrate to keep up with the excellence that I surround myself with on this show.
So, Derek, you concentrated on what we saw up in Minneapolis.
Yep.
And you just sense that this team had another gear. They turned it on. I thought they got jobbed against Purdue a little bit. Same thing against Illinois. I didn't love the way the games were officiated. But the way Chucky played defense and the way that this group played, Storr was taken over, I think this team is set in a great spot if they can recover from all that emotional energy that they used the last 4 days. Luckily, it's a Friday night game. You get the maximum amount of time. How did you view last weekend from your standpoint as a Badger fan?
Well, I definitely don't see fatigue as a problem. And you didn't even mention your positives. You didn't even mention Oklezie.
I'm a little nervous. It looked like he yanked a little groin.
We've shown some depth, but Oklezie disappeared. And then when it came to crunch time to come back and win that game, we went to Oklezie. He was the guy that was hitting his shot. So definitely we're in a much better spot. This is way more fun. And it sounds to me like my existential existence on this program depends on the success of this team. So I'm rooting for some shots to be made. Everything you mentioned, from Storr's athleticism to it looks like Chucky kind of got green-lighted, where they're like, you know, we're going to need some production from you. You're too good of a scorer to not look to score a little bit more. My concern comes, as it has all season, defensively. And I just keep getting fights with people on the interwebs about this idea that when we go on our droughts, right, it's been a Achilles heel for the Badgers for a long time. How do we get back on track? And I always think to myself, why not give Assisian a little bit of run to see if he can hit some shots to get us out of trouble? And I just get attacked. Like, he can't compete in this game. He can't defensively. He can't get up and down. He can't stop anybody. And yet we're giving up 90, 100 points. And I've always said to you guys, what are we going to give up, 120 if Assisian plays for 6 minutes? That's my concern, is we're going to get up against a hot hand and we're going to play a solid game, but we're not going to be able to have a hot hand to the old, like I always call it, the old Ricky Bauer sauce, where you get a guy that just is capable of getting hot and streaky and just starts making shots. We've said, you know, that's going way back with Ricky. But, man, over the course of time, when we've had teams that have gone long ways, we've had guys that are shooters in that Steve Kerr mold, where they're in the right spot, and if you get it to them, they can make that three-point shot. And that's what makes me nervous, is we score within the offense, but we don't have a lot of guys that are dependable down the stretch from three the way you need to be in the tournament.
I did see that Connor Assisian came out and said that he would not be entering the transfer portal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
which I respect about him.
I think he likes it here. I think he gets it. I think he understands why he doesn't get a ton of minutes. I mean, we're in a very physical league, and when you play at the top of the league, I see it too. Illinois's got some dogs. I have some hopes that Illinois are going to make a run. The Illini look good.
You have some hopes.
I like to see the Big Ten Conference do well. I hate the ACC. And a lot of other
things. I like the Big Ten doing well, too.
Yeah. If I definitely, like, I got on the Purdue train a couple years ago.
I like Purdue. It looks like a hard-fought squad. I mean, it's not Zach Edey's fault the refs don't know how to officiate him. Yeah, the refs can't officiate big-body dudes. They couldn't officiate for Shaq. They can't officiate for Zach Edey either. I'm not mad at Purdue at all. Go ahead, Derek.
No. I want to say that I think we're going to do well. I think Connor is in the right mindset. Just like you talked about, I saw the same thing, Jason. You got a good guy that can really score, and he made a couple in the tournament.
He did.
So
I just think Maryland game?
I think sometimes the juice is worth the squeeze to give him a little run because you can almost smell it. A.J. gets a little out of control off the dribble. Mm-hmm. He tends to turn the ball over a little bit, and then he sort of fades away, and then we start moving the ball, and we keep touching the post. I don't know if Kral's got the moves that you want to just continually run the offense through him. And Wall's another guy. Nice player. Really nice player. Tends to miss the bunnies, tends to make some plays at inopportune times that just make you
gritty, though. Very gritty.
Yeah, he's a guy that we need. I'm talking about really making a run here. Connor's been a great team guy. He's going to stay here. I think there are times in the game where he can be a deadly addition to the lineup. And I don't care because our defense, we just don't play as well as our best teams have played, and you can see that. It's quite obvious. And we're playing against some real athletes, and we're trying to play faster than we have in recent years because we do have some firepower offensively.
Yeah, I mean, when Storr gets it in the wing, I'm thinking Dunkaroo, man. He might be the most explosive athlete we've had here in 30 years. Is there anybody that's more explosive?
He's just different.
Can you think of anybody?
He's more explosive than Tucker was when he was at his peak.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
His first step, Jason.
From a Duncan.
When he gets to the rim, and he's an NBA guy. Like, I always tell my kids, like, you can be a really, 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 really good basketball player, and you're never going to go to the NBA. The NBA, you have to have some freakish athleticism.
Dream fearlessly.
Yep. And live dangerously. You know how it goes.
No, Derek, before we put a bow on this part of the conversation,
sure.
What I thought was the most interesting part.
Derek, just so you know, before he tells you the most interesting part, what's actually happening here is he really wants to get to commercial break so we can do our digi only. How many presidents can you name in the four and a half minutes?
So Derek is going to also do it. Write them down, and then we'll do a little score sheet. It's about 4 minute break. Uh-huh. How many you can get? Uh-huh. World War I is what caught. I saw Rob Vogel tweeted in. He got 38, which is a great number. World War I is what caught me. And being a history major, I was very disgusted with myself. Uh-huh. But, Derek, I thought Gardo challenging Kral and saying you need to do more, that is what really, I think, sparked both the Maryland Northwestern. You just saw him be more aggressive, and he sets the table as far as what goes on.
Yeah, but when I see the ball go into Steve, he takes a little long to take action. And sometimes then the offense will stall, and if he doesn't have the clear leverage, he tends to just try to kick it back out and restart. It's important. Look, we got to touch the post. I get that. I just when I look at that team about what we're missing, everybody can see the defensive part. It's just I would like to be able to – if Kral is going to attract some attention and play with his back to the basket and we get the double, can we swing that ball and get a corner guy, a guy that's going to hit the three? Because I love Storr getting to the rim, and I don't mind Storr shooting at all. But the way that he shoots, he's not the one I want taking those high-leverage situation three-pointers. And if you think about it, it might be Klesy. Oh, Klesy could be the guy. I don't know. He seems to be heating up, and if he's not hurt. But in the absence of that, I would just let's be honest. It could also end up being Chucky. Chucky's going to play good, but we need somebody threes. We need to be banging out threes if we're going to make a run.
I think those guys all have their roles. Obviously, some are bigger than others, but I think if this offense doesn't run through Kral, I don't think this offense is as efficient, and I think that they're not going to win. He needs to be a guy, even if it's not scoring a ton of points. He is the guy. Get it into the post. Let him distribute. Let you get matchups off of it. He needs to be a dog. You can maybe beat James Madison without it, but you ain't beating Duke if Kral is not going to be a dog.
It depends on the matchup, like you said. It depends on who we're playing against. Against more athletic teams where they're going to close on him or we're going to have to be a little more agile, I don't know if you run the offense through him necessarily, but, again, we need touches with the back of the basket to make some of our movement work. And sometimes it's painful to watch Wisconsin play. I didn't mind watching them in the tournament. And I'm way more
didn't
excited.
Mind. It was great. Saturday and Sunday was great basketball to watch. Up and down. Wisconsin scoring every possession. The beginning of the second half. Mind to watch. You're a Badgers outsider that loves this team.
I love the team.
It doesn't get much better than that.
I feel like, and this is my fault. My bad. Okay. I get caught up in the whistle. I get caught up with the refs. And I can do whatever I want because I'm a fan. I'm not a player. I'm not a coach on the team. Our team being treated unfairly, and it gives me just flashbacks to that Duke Krzyzewski ref job in the finals. I hate the way that we're treated. And then I start going on rants on Twitter and everything else, and it's beneath me because I understand there's things we should be doing to win the games.
Okay.
And so sometimes it gets physically difficult. Either the love is so deep and throbbing that I cannot.
Oh my God.
I cannot put my emotions aside and just watch the games as they are. My heart.
All right. Let's go Digi only, Jason. Digi only.
Kind of wish we'd have gone Digi only about 30 seconds ago. More?
Of course, you bring Bakhtiari on here. He swears up and down. I know we got a problem with that. I talk about my love and passion.
Oh, we had a problem.
Whoa, Nelly!
If I may, for a moment, to remind everyone when we go Digi only. So this will only be heard on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel, not the ESPN Milwaukee YouTube channel. So join us on the ESPN Madison YouTube stream or on the Wildy and Tausch stream from our Twitter and Facebook pages.
Jesse, can I chime in and help these guys, or is it just going, like, how is that going to work? Because I want to make sure I'm doing this legit. Jason, what do you got, hives over there? You're walking around and itching? Like, what is going on?
Well, you're asking for rules to something that many of our fans will not get a chance to see or hear. So,
it's Digi only.
Right, so ask for the rules once we get to the digital realm.
If a tree falls in the forest, it still makes a noise, you know.
That's fair, Jason.
Does it?
We're
going to name as many presidents as we can on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. If you'd like to join us and you're not on YouTube currently, that's where you will find this Digi only presidential extravaganza. Then we'll return to the radio airwaves, both terrestrial and streaming, with our Badgers outsider. After that, it's Wildy and Tausch.
This is Wildy and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
All right, everybody, we are live on the Digi only on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. And on Wildy and Tausch streaming on Twitter and Facebook.
Is it wrong that I was barely listening to Derek for much of that segment because I was trying to write down presidents? Does that make me a bad person?
You didn't start writing before the break.
Tausch told me I was supposed to start writing. How are we going to deliver the list if we...
All right, yep, let's go. Yeah, let's get moving. Can I chime in and help, or am I just sitting here?
So I went chronologically from backwards, from currently, and then I went from the start of the country that way, and this is how you end up where Tausch admitted he was, which was struggling with kind of that World War I 1800s era.
So I'm going to write down the ones that I struggled with, and I'll put those up on camera after you go through your list.
Okay. All right, let's give you, 2 minutes here you want to put on the clock?
Yeah, I'm rolling.
2 minutes. Ready? Okay. Go.
Biden, Trump, Obama, W. Bush, Clinton, H.W. Bush, Reagan, Carter, Ford, Nixon, LBJ, Kennedy, Eisenhower, Trumaning up, FDR, Hoover, Coolidge, Harding. Woodrow Wilson, and then I couldn't remember who came before him.
Great one. Good one, Jason.
And then at the beginning of the process, perhaps you've heard of him, Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Madison, Monroe, another Adams, Jackson, Van Buren. And then I couldn't remember who was after him. So that's where I'm at. Anybody got any help for me?
I've got Fillmore.
Yeah, I can help.
Fillmore, yep. Garfield, Coolidge, Harrison, Johnson.
Yep.
Johnson was...
Polk and Pierce.
And all these
are
lawyers.
There you go. I was just going to tell you.
Lawyers.
Headlines. Headlines. Go to headlines. And don't forget the Bachelor president. Don't forget the presidents that were assassinated. That's how you have to start thinking about this. That's where your mind goes.
Andrew Johnson.
I didn't get Wilson and Coolidge.
Cleveland with two... Didn't Cleveland have two different gigs?
He did.
Two different routines.
Yep. James Polk. How about Polk?
We got Polk just a minute
ago. How about
the
heavy set bathtub guy? Don't forget him.
Kohler Services. Did someone actually say Lincoln?
You guys have not. No.
I didn't hear Lincoln.
So how many do you have, Jason?
Ulysses S. Grant.
Nice. Chester
Teddy
Arthur.
Teddy Roosevelt. Did we say Teddy Roosevelt?
Yes.
I have both FDR. Roosevelt.
I've got you at 38 right now.
You vogled it.
Garfield?
You vogled it.
Five,
Garfield,
four,
McKinley,
three,
Buchanan.
Taft. Did we say Taft?
Who was the bathtub president?
Who was the CIA guy?
Hoover? We're going to count Taft, and that's a total of
Hoover.
39. 39.
Out of 46.
Rutherford B. Hayes? Did we forget about Rutherford?
We missed Rutherford B.
So we get Chester Arthur.
I'm gonna get a phone.
I just yelled him.
I'm gonna get a phone call from Rutherford B. Hayes' great 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 granddaughter. How could you leave him?
McKinley?
Out?
Did you guys get McKinley and Garfield and Buchanan?
I don't have Buchanan. So
this is
John
the problem.
Tyler. Yeah, Tippy Canoe and Tyler
too. We did not get John Tyler. I don't think we got Zachary Taylor either.
I guess we should have had a checklist, and that probably would have made this a little bit easier to keep track of.
I think both people watching this should be pretty impressed right now.
That's it for the Digi. Back to the radio.
Both people watching this.
0.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
If you didn't join us for our Digi Only on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel of us shouting presidents' names.
And many of you didn't.
You didn't really miss that much. But we would have liked it if you joined us. Jesse, where did we officially end?
Between Jason and Derek and then Tausch at the buzzer, 39 presidents. Of the possible 45, I think we were at.
I think we're at 46 now. I think.
But Cleveland was two.
Biden is 46.
So, 45 total. So there were six presidents that were missed.
John Tyler was one of them.
Yeah. Tippecanoe and Tyler too.
That's
Tippecanoe not a president though, right?
Wasn't it Taylor too? But
no.
That
was Tyler.
Huh. Be an American, Jesse. Know your history.
Yeah, come on, Jesse.
As much as I'd like to relive our Digi Only now for our terrestrial radio listeners, Derek, what else is on your mind Badgers related? Because we were going to break about 5 minutes before that, and then Tausch kept you going, and then we got into how Zachy's officiated. So what else is on your mind before we say goodbye?
Well, I thought you guys were going to ask me for my hot tips for the first round of the tournament.
Nope. I'm interested.
I spent literally minutes.
Let's hear your tips.
Minutes researching.
Okay.
Well, you know, the more I think about it, the more I'm not really sure. hoping we would kind of skip all that, get on as
Do you have any tips?
I tell you what.
You have nothing.
As I filled out my bracket with the children last night, as all families in America should. You know, I couldn't figure out Kansas is a four, and I couldn't really figure out who was going to beat them. So that Kansas-Creighton region is kind of interesting for folks to maybe take a look at. You know, I heard Ben Bruss say Creighton was going to really go far, so that kind of gave
me a little way.
That influenced me.
No way.
Actually, this James Madison thing, you know, my boys brought up a good point last night. I was like, guys, they don't play in a great conference. A lot of the good players have been siphoned off. But they've only lost three games. Anytime you can go out with a squad and only lose three games, that makes me nervous. So Wisconsin probably has one of the more intriguing matchups of the first round, which you can't always say that. But really, I was starting to research Iowa State. Iowa State's interesting. They're a two seed, and you just don't think, other than what back when they had the mayor, Fred Hoiberg, was playing, you don't think of Iowa State as being a contender. So I kind of wonder how they're going to look. And I definitely see Purdue exiting early for the reasons we talked about. they're going to come up in a game against some athletes and some referees who are going to be like, ah, you're not just going to run all over the place and knock people over and get the benefit of the doubt on the whistle. And I think even though they have a strong backcourt, they're going to struggle. So my hot take is I think the best prepared team coming out is Illinois, because they've got that they've got some three-point shooters, they've got some athleticism, and they can play some defense. I like Underwood's squad, and if I come back and I'm still on the show, I would say that would be the one I would want to answer to is Illinois' run. And of course, our friends in Milwaukee, I'll be rooting on Marquette. Anytime Marquette's got a good team, I want them to go, because there is a potential Wisconsin Marquette matchup.
Yeah,
that would be elite the dream, eight. And that would be an That'd elite be eight run-in that I dream of.
Based on your minutes of intensive study,
yes.
Is it okay for me to like Arizona? I like Arizona. Having seen them play a few times, and I have this vision of their point guard, Love, is it?
They beat our breaks in. Yep. They beat our breaks in.
Yes, they did. And I would like to see him play Carolina in the tournament, which he transferred out of Carolina to go to Arizona. That's the intriguing matchup. Did that come across your desk during your minutes of preparation?
I did. This is terrible. I was going to talk about Arizona today because I picked them to win last night, but I didn't want anybody that might play in my pools to know that. So I didn't disclose because I remember the beating we took.
You didn't want to say it publicly.
At home, I picked Arizona to be my winner in my bracket last night. I didn't want to. I when I say minutes, you know,
so I just outed you onto you.
Yeah, I was. Yeah.
Sweet.
I started filling in and paying to enter a bracket when I was in fifth grade. So when I was 11 years old, and I've never won. I've been in many. I've been in hundreds. And so I'm usually hold my expertise pretty close to the vest. And I have
Apparently
Arizona.
For no real reason.
What good is that if you've never won?
Well, as a respected pundit in certain area codes, mainly the 608, maybe the southern or northern parts of Dane County with limited, I don't know. Let's just be honest. Anything can happen. None of these teams are appreciably better than the other. You know, my boys are looking at the seeds last night. I was like, guys, throw the seeds away for the most part. Anything can happen in these games, with the exception of teams that can't compete physically with the North Carolinas and the Purdue's of the world in the early rounds. But I see good things happening because it's going to be one of those wild tournaments, and I think there's going to be some good stories to be told. Would have liked to see Indiana State in. That was the big one I didn't love, but that's really about it. I think it's a good week because you sit back and watch. You let the game come to you, so to speak, as a fan. And that's where you want to be. Set up with a couple of brewskis, Coors Lights, and sitting there ready to take it all in. Stopping a quick
well
trip
done.
at the yep. table. Hope you run into an old friend like Jesse. Maybe rescue him because he's been at the sample table for longer than is allowed by law and by quick trip policy. Just trying to do everybody a favor and keep everybody safe out there.
Derek, since your punditry is so impressive and because you dropped so many different partner references, a little disappointed you didn't go Johnson and Sons Paving at some point there, because they've obviously, you know, been mentioned a lot.
Well,
with Tausch's upcoming internship.
It's delicate because I there's been rumblings that Tausch might be he may not be nimble enough to work around some of the jobs, and they're worried about his stamina. And I didn't want to bring that out publicly, but hoping he can learn if that career is right for him. But I got a reference call, and I said he's going to go out there, and I think he's going to be eager to learn, but I don't know what those bad knees and the heat is not good for old T.
Oh, boy.
So
all right,
just
Derek, before you go, what do you anticipate Wisconsin finding its way through, or do you think with James Madison only having three losses and then a potential matchup with Duke lurking in the weeds for Sunday, will you be back next week, in your opinion, with the Badgers still in play?
God, you know, I've made some big predictions, and a lot of them have been wrong. So I'm going to say, though, I think we'd have a hard time getting through Duke. I know Shire doesn't really bring the same moxie, and it's not gone that great, but I still think that's a difficult – I don't feel good about it. Now, we've got two tough ones. This could be my swan song.
Well, isn't Duke without their best player? Didn't he suffer some sort of major injury in a court storming incident where he had to have his leg amputated? Phil, did I miss that story?
He's got the same injury Caitlin Clark's got, the one where they're hurt. They're hurt feelings.
But he pushed his way through. So that was not a season-ending injury? Because at the moment that it happened, it really looked like quite frankly, I thought maybe it was life-threatening based on his reaction.
Well, it was a shoulder block. And I'm sure he's going to be just fine.
Yeah. Derek, just in case you won't be back next week, you want to stick around and ask one of the trivia questions?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
What an honor to bestow.
Rarefied air.
Jason doesn't think they're winning this weekend.
This has really turned into a bit of a funeral. A certain Paul has come over. Tausch was in such a good mood today. And now the idea that his old friend might just be on death's doorstep.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll go ahead. I'm gonna work through the tears. There's a lot of emotions bubbling up.
Atta boy.
I'll get through it.
Derek, what caller would you like?
Caller six.
Caller six.
If I come back next year, it'll be year six, and I'm gonna be a swiper in that elevator, and I'm gonna let myself up.
You're still not getting a swiper. I'm afraid to state. Caller six for Badgers Trivia Tuesday, 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. Caller six will play trivia with Tausch and Derek and me and Jesse. Coming up next, after Tausch tells us about Prize Picks.
Oh, Prize Picks. We just had a fun little pseudo Prize Picks with how many presidents you can name. Well, we're not going to do that with Prize Picks, but you got college hoops. You got the NBA. You got all that fun golf. Prize Picks has it all. It is the number one daily fantasy sports app, and it is simple. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections for a wide variety of stats, and place your entry. It's that easy. Download the Prize Picks app. Use that code WI. Again, that's code WI on Prize Picks for a first deposit match up to $100. Prize Picks. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
Trivia's next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin Sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. To apply today, go to stojobs.com. For the 15th time in program history, the Wisconsin women's hockey team is headed to the Frozen Four. With a 4-0 win over St. Lawrence at LeBond on Saturday, the reigning national champion Badgers have the opportunity to defend their crown this weekend in Durham, New Hampshire. Wisconsin will face off with Colgate in the Frozen Four, with the winner headed to the national championship game on Sunday. Clarkson and conference foe Ohio State will face off in the other semifinal. Puck drop between Colgate and Wisconsin set for 6:30 this Friday on ESPN+.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
At UW Credit Union, our home loans have everything you need for your next big step, including up to $750 off closing costs for all home buyers. And first-time buyers can save even more. So if you're ready to trade roomies for more room, or your town home for an out-of-town home, UW Credit Union will be with you from start to furnished. UW Credit Union. Apply online today. Equal housing lender. Credit may be limited as required by program. Visit uwcu.org for details.
Madison athletes seeking elite training need to get started today at Total Athlete Performance. TAP is here to serve and educate the serious athlete with their speed, agility, and semi-private training options. Sessions are now available in both Windsor and their TAP facility inside the Verona Athletic Center. Also access remote training anytime, anywhere with the Total Athlete Performance app. Visit TAPWisconsin.com for subscriptions, including monthly payment options. That's TAPWisconsin.com.
The madness is back, and so is your chance at proving your hoops knowledge. It's the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge, presented by Cousin Subs. Fill out a bracket, earn the most points at the end of the tourney, and get a $1,000 gift card to Cousin Subs. Fill out your bracket on ESPN.com or the ESPN Tournament Challenge app. Just search ESPN Wisconsin and enter the password Cousins. It's the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge, presented by Cousin Subs. They believe in better. Visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com for full rules and details.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
There's a new safety in town.
Xavier McKinney is somebody who is what exactly we're looking for this defense. Talk about knees, talk about fit. This is a great fit for this defense.
Nobody covers the green and gold like 100.5 ESPN.
Trivia. Let's welcome in our contestant. It is Nate in Mount Horeb. Nate, good morning. How are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Great. We've got Badgers Trivia Tuesday for you, and you get to play with Derek Blakeslee. Derek, which question would you like to ask? One, two, or three?
I'd like question three.
Okay. We'll crescendo.
All right. I want a big fit. I want to know, is Nate Mount Horeb, is he ready to be he may be a part of history. He should be prepared for that and be focused on what he's doing. This could be my swan song.
I'm focused.
All right, Nate. Don't let me down.
All right.
Tosh, you have questions.
All right, Nate. Which of these Northeast states is the host site of the 2024 Women's Frozen Four featuring the Wisconsin Badgers making yet another championship run? Is it New Hampshire, New Jersey, or New Maine?
What was the second one?
New Jersey.
The first one was New Hampshire?
Correct.
I'm going with New Hampshire.
Correct. One for one, Nate. He's locked in. Question two.
My phone's about to die.
Oh my God.
Wisconsin men's basketball is one of five teams to reach the NCAA tournament in 23 of the last 25 seasons. Which of these is the only other Big Ten team to have reached the big dance more than Wisconsin in the last quarter century? Is it Purdue, Michigan State, or Indiana?
Michigan State.
I feel like there's a clock ticking now.
My God, Derek Blakeslee, this is high drama. It's high drama. A race against time. Nate, question three. Which of these opponents was the last team Wisconsin defeated when playing in the second round of the men's NCAA tournament? Is it Xavier, Villanova, or Oregon?
The last time we won in the second round?
Which of these opponents was the last team Wisconsin defeated when playing in the second round?
Oregon.
Let that phone die, Nate. Let it die.
All right.
The urgency. I feel like our urgency was higher than Nate's there,
he's
too.
Like, what are you at?
Very
Nate,
calm.
What percentage are you at on the phone, Nate?
Probably less than 10.
Well, that's what you gave
oh,
on.
You got all day.
That's the effort you gave on question three, Nate.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I'm emotional. I take it back.
Jeez, we invite you to stick around and you insult our contestants.
Oh, snap.
Was it Xavier?
No, you touched it.
Nice work, Nate.
Villanova.
Attaboy, Nate.
Correct. I mean, right. I guess I should correct that and say, according to Jesse's posting, it is Villanova. We may have to double-check that fact
They
now.
Defeated Villanova right. in 2017 before reaching the Sweet 16 at Madison Square Garden with Shoei in the belt and the whole hoopla there. Yeah.
That was a great moment.
Number one overall seed, Villanova.
Nate, you got two out of three. You got three of the four entries into Friday's drawing. Good luck to you, and go find a charger. Maybe you can use the one that Tausch left at the airport.
Will do. Thanks a lot.
I think that is Will D. Tausch trivia.
Doesn't Tausch keep some things in his cubby like that? I've gone through it so many times. I think I've used his chargers and headsets.
You're really trying to burn every bridge on the way out of here this week, huh?
I've got a flair for the dramatic.
You better hope they don't
beat
Duke.
I just wanted him so bad. I wanted him to get that right so bad. And those questions were so hard, Jesse.
It would have been a great walk-off, no doubt about it.
Story of my life. I get to the big finish, and then it just falls flat.
That sounds like something you need to talk over with a professional. Derek, I don't know. I don't know if I can do this. I don't know if I have the power to do this. But win or lose, you know the old Badger saying, win or lose, we still booze. I've seen that on some T-shirts around the Camp Randall area. Win or lose, I think you should come back next week. I don't think your appearance should be contingent on whether they win or lose.
I just didn't know what the rule was. I can't go out like this.
I agree with Jason.
I can't go out like this.
No, you had a bad effort to finish, so... Derek will be back next Tuesday.
That wasn't a bad effort.
We'll see you next Tuesday, Derek.
Thanks, guys. Go Badgers. I hope we win.
Derek Blakeslee tipped his hand inadvertently, or because of me, that he's picking Arizona to win the whole shooting match. So if you want to be like Derek and enter our bracket challenge presented by Cousin Subs, we believe in better, and do better than Derek, well, you better get the other teams right if you're going to pick Arizona, because that's who he's got. The madness is back, and so is your chance at proving your hoops knowledge. And see if it's better than Derek's. It's the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge presented by Cousin Subs. All you got to do is fill out a bracket, earn the most points at the end of the tourney, and you'll win a $1,000 gift card to Cousin Subs. So fill out your bracket either at ESPN.com or in the ESPN Tournament Challenge app. Just search ESPN Wisconsin. Enter the password Cousins, all lowercase. Cousins, all lowercase. It's the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge presented by Cousin Subs. We believe in better. Visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com for full rules and details. The 11 o'clock hour of Will D. Tausch kicks off in 2 minutes, so stick around.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Hey, this is Eric Name of The Athletic. You're listening to Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN, WTLX Monona, Madison, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison, and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge, presented by Cousin Subs. Fill out a bracket in the ESPN Tournament Challenge on ESPN.com. Use group code COUSINS
and you'll have a chance to win a $1,000 Cousin Subs gift card. Official rules at ESPNWisconsinContests.com. The Wisconsin Badgers and the Marquette Golden Eagles both tip off their tournament runs on Friday. Marquette gets the go first Friday afternoon, 1 o'clock tip time in Indianapolis as the 2-seed Golden Eagles take on 15-seed Western Kentucky. Marquette is opened as a 14-point favorite for that game, according to ESPN Bet. Then, Friday night, approximate tip time, 8:40 in Brooklyn, New York. Number 5-seed Wisconsin, number 12-seed James Madison. Despite being a popular 12-5 upset pick, according to many experts, Wisconsin is listed as a 5.5-point favorite on ESPN Bet. Joe Lenardi, one of the experts, resident ESPN bracketologist, shares his projections for both Wisconsin and Marquette. Check it out over at ESPNWisconsin.com. Meanwhile, NBA bucks off until tomorrow night when they visit the Boston Celtics. Big game in the Eastern Conference. Tip time set at 6:30.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Begins now. And we were, you know, we got so in depth into that trip to Brazil that the Packers aren't taking during the 9 o'clock hour that we never got to a little game we like to call Did You Hear This? The David Bakhtiari edition. Now, we talked to David on Friday, and you'll be reading about what he said in the Wisconsin State Journal tomorrow.
Double dip.
Double dip.
I'm going to do some transcribing first. But there was some really interesting stuff there. Now, before we play him, Tausch, I did get asked a question, so I want to warn you because I want to get to this after we play a little of what he said. But I was asked a question because there's some chatter, internet chatter, about him and a injury grievance and whether or not he could recoup some of the money, pay that man his money, for this year's contract. Because as we talked about weeks ago, he can't pass a physical right now.
No.
And they cut him. And so what are the ramifications of that? So we'll get into that a little bit later. I want folks to hear, if you didn't hear him, you can find the full interview on Wisconsin On Demand. You can find it on Spotify. You can probably fast forward around on YouTube and find it as well. It was in the 11 o'clock hour of Friday's show. But I thought it was interesting how he talked about his injury and the frustration there was in the building. And here is that portion of the conversation.
Everyone understood. It was just like, I don't think they understood like the magnitude. And I think some information probably was displayed not properly. So I think it was more of a miscommunication. I don't think anyone understands, you know, the magnitude of the surgery that I had and the fact I was non-weight bearing for 8 weeks. And then, you know, just kind of coming back and kind of not really, it's like being welcome, but not at the same time is the best way to describe it. And then I'm like, well, okay. And this guy, I'm understanding, you know, I guess my girlfriend moved on. Okay, that's fine. But like, I'm an adult. We can have a conversation about it.
So when he says being welcome, but not really, what does that mean to you? Cause that when in real time, I believe I gave you a look as he said that, cause we were in studio together, which really makes for great radio when you and I are in the same place. What did you make of that?
So I think one of the things when you get injured is you want to still feel as much of a part of it, but you're not. And you want, you know, I think there's also, you start kind of thinking things in your own head, and it's that much easier to validate those thoughts when you see a couple of things go, maybe I've been treated so great when I'm the starter, and when, oh, everybody will do whatever it is that I'll do it. And then you become a back burner guy where it's, you don't really, you're not really worried about it because you're not helping the immediacy of the team. And then you start thinking, well, I know this is my last time here. So you're going to, everything is, I guess, hyperinflated in your head as far as, well, I didn't get an ice bag right away, or I didn't get my treatment right away.
So you see everything as a slight?
You do. No, you do. And sometimes it's not accurate, but it doesn't matter because that's the perception of how you have it. Now, there's also, you know, things that happen that aren't slights. It's just the reality that, hey, you're not one of the guys lacing them up and going out and playing, mm-hmm. and you're not as involved. So for as much as you can go to meetings and do, you always are trying to do whatever you can to help the team win, regardless. But when you're injured, there is an isolation to it that I can't really describe to people until you're there. And when you see that and then also see that the end of your time in Green Bay is more than likely, you're going to feel the way that David felt.
How did you handle that? Because you're talking from experience.
Yeah, no, it's the same thing. You want to be involved. You want to help, but you know you're just not, you're not having this. You get into this because you want to be impactful. You want to make a good living, and you want to help win. You want to do all this stuff. And while you're still doing it to the degree that you can, there is a part of you that there's not a lot, there's not much you can do. And then when you have somebody in the front office or in the training room or in the locker room, it doesn't matter. Little things that normally would never bother you will bother you because you have more time to kind of think about it. You're sitting there in a swimming pool doing rehab. You're doing rehab on a table. You're doing this. And unfortunately, your mind can go places where, you know, they're going to go. And that's why I always say flee in those guys for as much as they're, you know, physically they're getting you back, you know, if it's mobility and trying to get your muscles back to where they need to be and you get to run and all that stuff, it's probably 10 times more important to keep the mentals up. That was why I appreciate what Mark Lavotte did, what Flea did, what those guys did, is because it wasn't just, all right, go in and hit 50 squats. It was also, hey, man, I'm not having a day. And they'd sit, and that's why I love those guys, because they were there for me in times where I needed it, and I could speak to, and I saw Jordy Nelson when he got inducted in the Packer Hall of Fame. Who spoke?
And Nate Weir introduced
Flea.
Him. Yeah.
Nate Weir. You have those same – they're important pieces to the whole puzzle, and I just think David understood that and saw that, and that is a part of – his rehab, just like it was for every other player that goes through that.
Do you agree that because of the way, you know, LaFleur, we talked about it with him when we were talking with him, you know, the way LaFleur showed his frustration publicly, right, and didn't seem to know what was going on, like David saying that he was non-weight-bearing for 8 weeks, I would tell you that it was not articulated publicly very well by him or by the organization or whomever of how invasive the surgery was, right? Because we went from him playing in the opener and then this kind of several weeks of not knowing what exactly was going on and no one really being very clear about it, to then you're telling me that this surgery that he eventually underwent in November was so invasive that he was on crutches for 8 weeks. That's what that means. And not able to walk at all on it. That's a big surgery then, and I don't know if we ever knew that it was that severe.
No, and it's none of our business, but it is Matt LaFleur's business. And I think the frustrating part for him was, you know, he has already went through this whole process of not practicing and missing a bunch of training camp and still counting on him to play. I think coaches, They obviously want their best players playing. But what they don't want to have is a ton of uncertainty. Matt LaFleur, he never knew because, well, he didn't practice Thursday. What does that mean? Well, I don't know. He's not practicing Friday. What does that mean? I don't know. And then Saturday night comes, and you're like, I don't think he's going to play. And, well,
right.
Okay, well, these guys got this reps, but do you call a game differently? Do you, you know, he's a great player. And even in the game he played well. The frustration came from the unknown, and I think what we heard in that interview, and I'm not going to speak for David. He had a chance to speak for himself. I think there was a lot of miscommunication, and mm-hmm. I don't know how much trust there was between all of the departments as far as how they handled his injury, and I don't know about it from their perspective, how they feel in the same respect. And when you have all that, then you have, well, I'm not going to tell you this. I'm not going to talk about this. I'll practice when I can, and I'll play when I can. That's not tenable. It wasn't tenable. And when I heard LaFleur say what he said on that Wednesday, is, you know, you saw the frustration bubble. That's when I knew bad things were on the horizon. Because he doesn't have – he loves David Bakhtiari as a player. There's no doubt. I think he just was incredibly frustrated because he felt like, this is not helpful for this football team to have all of this uncertainty.
All right, let's play the other two clips in the next segment, but let me ask you this then to put a bow on the injury part of the conversation. The idea that he has a grievance that he could potentially file, and I know that word carries a certain connotation. I don't know if he feels aggrieved by the team, but the point of the matter is, he would have to argue, I was looking this up on the NFLPA website because Jen Gabe and Chewy wanted to talk about it this morning, and that they're not signing maybe free agents because they feel like they're going to lose some cap space if they were to lose this grievance and have to pay out his salary for this season. But it, the actual injury itself traces back to December 31st, 2020, but he could argue, since he did play in a game last season, that there was an aggravation or whatever it might have been in the Bears game, and that led to this surgery. You, having been an NFLPA rep, where does this kind of go, and how long will we be in limbo for how long it'll take before this is decided, whether or not the Packers owe him? Because it's not just the money that they would be paying him, that he'd be getting from the Packers. It would also be how it affects their cap space.
Yeah, so this is two CBAs ago is the only thing I can go off of. And in essence, if you had 3 years on your deal and you had a monster injury in year one of that three-year deal and you were not able to pass a physical or play, you don't get your full salary. You would get a percentage up to, I think at that point in time, it was up to $2 million. And then the third year, it's a little bit less. It's, again, if you can't pass a physical from that injury, you are entitled, but it was not salary cap adjacent. It was just you were getting it, and I think it was through the insurance company and whatnot. I don't know what the next CBA entailed. I know owners were very irritated with that because it felt like, I think some owners thought that guys would sign 2 and 3 year deals, and that's why you saw more 1 and 2 year contracts at the back end of guys' careers, because if you get hurt, and you're not going to rehab it, you could just say, well, I can't play, you owe me for this. And, you know, David's making 20-some million or supposed to. He won't get anywhere near that. But my guess, especially if there's salary cap ramifications, which I don't know, you'll have to do that research.
Yeah, I will.
My guess would be there'll be a settlement that will, you know, make everybody whole. And then hopefully, in David's case, as he mentioned with us Friday, if he's able to, I think he would love to get back out there and play.
Mm-hmm.
I think the surgery he had is a monster undertaking, if that is going to be the case. I think he is going to be behind the eight ball as far as getting a chance to get back out and play, but continue to rehab and try to get as much of that money that the Packers owe him, where I know fans are going to be irritated, but that's the reality. That's business. Ask Devondre Campbell. You cut him when he had a bunch of money left on his deal. And you know what? Nobody's saying, well, they should pay him that. This is one of those little precautions that players have, and he should utilize it to whatever degree he can.
Boy, Bulaga was really fired up about Devondre Campbell. I did the Homer Hour with him at Homer last night. It was, He's really fired up about that. We'll have to talk to him about that further tomorrow. It was good stuff. He was very good. Speaking of very, very, very good, tomorrow not only will Brian Bulaga join our show, but Gina Della is coming to my house along with her crew to look at my window. I'm very excited about that.
Special you to have Gina on a house call. She's the GOAT. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin is the GOAT. And if you've been waiting to replace those broken windows or doors, or if you just want to revitalize your home with a new look, now is the time to get it done. Because from now until March 31st, 0% interest for 3 years with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's right, Pella now and pay later. 3 years later, in fact. Order by March 31st, get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
More from our David Bakhtiari interview next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
You're probably being overwhelmed with information about semaglutide, the game-changing FDA-approved weight loss treatment. Jim Rutledge here. I was like you. I didn't know what it was until I saw Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. He can walk you through the benefits. He can tell you if it's right for you, and then you could come up with a plan to change your life with a workout plan and semaglutide. With that plan, I dropped 20% body fat to 10% body fat, and I dropped over 20 pounds of fat and kept my muscle. You can do the same thing. Go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health.
Goodman's Jewelers has been providing a sparkle to Madison since 1933. That's a lot of great memories. John Hayes for Goodman's Jewelers. We've been caring for generations of customers, and during that time, our strengths have been trust, service, and selection. Those traits are who we are, and that will never change. Goodman's Jewelers, a destination worth reaching. 220 State Street, goodmansjewelers.com.
The best is at Goodman's.
Ben Brust here to tell you about why your next work van should be from Mercedes-Benz Sprinter at Zimbrick European. First off, we have versatility. The Sprinter vans offer 16 body types and thousands of ways to customize that space. Number two, we have reliability. Sprinter's most powerful diesel engines last longer and require less maintenance, spend more time in the road, and less time in those bays. Number three, we have safety. Sprinter's safety technologies include curtain airbags all around, load adaptive electronic stability program, and crosswind and attention assist. Number four, Van Care Mobile. Our maintenance team can come to you with routine service. Who wants to go in? Let them come to you. They work with multiple trucks on one visit. Use the Mercedes Me Connect. And last but not least, get your Zimbrick Sprinter at Zimbrick European at Rimrock Road and the Beltline, or go online at ZimbrickEuropean.com, because they never charge over the MSRP.
Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company is a Madison original, brewing award-winning craft beers for nearly 30 years. Whether you're a fan of Pilsners, IPAs, Stouts, or Sours, the Dane's team of brewers always have something new on tap. Or if you're in the mood for a classic, enjoy the German Pilsner or Crop Circle Wheat. For a full tap list, head to one of their locations in Fitchburg, Hilldale, Downtown, or East Madison, or visit GreatDanePub.com. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
Listen to Madison Money Guy every Saturday morning at 7 a.m. on 100.5 ESPN and ESPNWisconsin.com.
I like to refer to inflation as the silent killer. It's an invisible risk. It's just the idea that things get more expensive over time. You're going to need milk and eggs when you're in your early 60s and when you're in your early 80s. You're going to get a loaf of bread, and it's going to be more expensive 20 years from now.
Christian Finfrock is the Madison Money Guy. Call him today at 208-1800.
Our kids deserve the best we can give them. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher. If you're looking for somewhere that kids can learn, play, and enjoy family fun all at once, then register today in one of the spring youth programs at the Prairie Athletic Club with 6 basketball courts, a full-size indoor soccer field, and swim lessons at one of the 5 indoor pools. They've got it all. Join today or visit as a guest and discover why the PAC is consistently voted the best place to work out and best thing for kids to do year after year. Visit PrairieAthletic.com. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
David Bakhtiari. Again, you can hear the entirety of the interview on Wisconsin On Demand, Spotify, Google Play, Apple Podcasts, TuneIn Radio. You can read some of it in tomorrow's State Journal or on Madison.com. But he told us not to compare Jordan Love to Aaron Rodgers. And some might say, no good blank, luck. Blank. But others might say, you can't avoid it. Here's what David Bakhtiari said.
All of our eyes are tainted, all the men in this conversation currently, because you've seen a generational guy attack the position, and it taints your view. I literally remember Goody telling all the scouts that you cannot evaluate the quarterback position. It's hard to evaluate the quarterback position, and you have to have a governor on you when you go out to practice, because Aaron's going to make at least one throw a day that is going to taint your view on how to evaluate quarterbacks. And I strongly do believe that. And I think that is, again, really hard shoes to fill. But at the end of the day, there's more than one way to skin a cat. Just because Aaron's so amazing at what he can do, there's different ways to play the position to be extremely effective. Because if it wasn't, then Aaron would have won every single Super Bowl every year he's ever played.
So do you think our eyes are tainted? The three men in this conversation, which I appreciate him including me in it, do you think our eyes are tainted by how great Rodgers is? Because it does feel like we are getting ourselves, and not just with our discussion of paying him as much as possible, we're pretty overwhelmed by how good he looked in the 9 to 10 games to end the year.
All right. Now, first off, not paying him as much as possible. Less than the top guys, but more than Daniel Jones. So I don't know why you keep going there.
$52 million.
I'm not going to 52, which is about fourth right now before the cap went up. But
tied
whatever.
For third.
I'm not going to get. Yeah. Well, at this point, there's guys that are going to get paid. Whatever. I don't know why you keep doing that. But our eyes tainted. I think perspective can be, but I also think we've done a pretty good job of understanding that he wasn't going to be Aaron Rodgers. Now, the pundits, and how many times did we watch a game last year where they would show video?
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my God, he just did what Brett Favre did. Oh, my gosh, he's jumping and he's throwing the ball like Aaron Rodgers did. So it's just natural that you're going to get those comps.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, hey, welcome to the NFL, brother. Welcome to being a quarterback for the G&G. It is a highly, we expect greatness. That's what we expect.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't expect it. I knew there'd be growing pains. We played Kirk Cameron's song constantly. Alan Thicke and the whole crew, Judy Light.
Joanna Kearns,
Tony Danza,
not Judith
the
Lights.
Whole deal. We listened to it and we expected it, but we expected him to step up, and that's why I didn't like everybody babying him. Because listen, you're the starting quarterback for the G&G. That's a big blanking deal. And what we've seen is he's not Aaron Rodgers yet, but boy, did he certainly look the part the last 10 weeks of that season in the postseason up until that fourth quarter of the Niners game. He looked the part. And so are our eyes tainted? Heck yeah, they are. But you know what? We want to have our eyes. If you go in, you want those glasses to have green and gold. Like, that's the expectation. We ain't looking through purple and white or black and orange glasses. We're looking through green and gold glasses because that's the expectation that we have. And by the way, Jordan Love lived up to that for the vast majority of last season. And part of having greatness continue on is that guys set bars. They set the bar, and you don't want to be the guy to break that link in the chain. You don't want that. You're going to work, and that's why great programs continue to be great. Guys go to Duke because they want to be part of the brotherhood. Guys come to Green Bay and be quarterback. They don't want to be, no offense to Randy Wright, they don't want Randy Wright's career. They want to be Brett Blankenfarve and Aaron Blankenrodgers. So that's how this thing goes, and fortunately, at least for a small sample size, that's what Jordan Love's done.
So is it the bar or the links in the chains? I got lost in the metaphor.
It can be both. Jason, different people learn and listen and hear things in different ways. I don't want to be a one-trick analogical pony. I want to have it where I can give you two or three different visuals.
Sure.
And give you those analogies and let you pick which one you want to visualize.
I prefer thanalysis over your analogous. I'm curious if your discussion of paying Jordan Love traces back to this final clip we're going to play from our conversation with David Bakhtiari.
If I'm Jordan, and like right now, I mean, like, again, he can take up as much pie as he wants. It doesn't affect any other, like, I'm not in the rooms anymore. So, I mean, if you don't pay him, then what? What are you going to do, Green Bay? Like, are you really going to try and keep flirting with the idea of going back to like the 70s and 80s, the things that I heard about Green Bay, where guys we used to say, like, around the league, like, you better wise up or I'm going to send you up to Green Bay. Like,
Siberia back
that.
Then. Yeah.
Exactly. And here's the thing. He's a fantastic young ascending player. He's an unbelievable person. He's great in the community. Yeah, I mean, if he's asking for 50, Russ is amazing at his job. He can make it work.
Is that where it all began? Is that where the wheels started turning for you?
No, I've been saying this for a while. I've seen the way the cap is exploding. And if Jordan Love is going to be really, really good, he should be paid really, really high. And I know Packer fans want him to wildy it and say, well, this is fair, 42, 43, whatever it might be. But yesterday's price isn't today's price. And guess what? Next April's price isn't going to be this April's price. You don't believe me? Go to the Blanken grocery store, man. Check out the price of eggs. Go ahead and look at what all this stuff costs.
Bacon's pretty cheap
it
right
ain't
now,
the
though,
same.
At Quick Trip.
It ain't the same. So you're going to, at some point, have to move all your chips in and say, Jordan Love is our guy. I don't want to go DPE in the G&G. I don't want that. I want Patrick Mahomes, Joe Burrow, Josh Allen, where, hey, if I need to move some money around because we got a Xavier McKinney we want to get, I want to be able to convert and do it and spread it out. That's not what the Dallas Cowboys are able to do because they never really wanted to pay him until they pulled on those finger, until they pulled him across and they forced him to. That's what I'm trying to avoid,
in retrospect,
and I believe we will.
Were they right not to want to pay him because he hasn't gotten them anywhere?
No. Dak Prescott has won them divisions. No. Dak Prescott's been everything they've wanted in Dallas in the regular season. He has.
That's pretty important.
Has he played well enough in the postseason? Has he? Is that what you're going to start judging it on?
I'm just saying.
No, that's what. Jason, let me ask you this: you think Dallas would prefer to have Dak Prescott on a rolling 3-4 year contract where they're able to move it around and say, "Oh, we don't want to lose Tyron Smith for $6 million," but Dak's taking up $56 million in the cap. We can't pay him. Or would they say, man, if we would have paid him, we probably have gotten him for 36 instead of 44, and now we'd be playing that game.
No, you're not understanding.
Dak has been a really good quarterback that most teams would have loved to have had leading their franchise for the last six years.
Because we talk a lot about Aaron Rodgers. We spent a lot of time a couple weeks ago talking about how they only had one title, all this other stuff. And whether or not it was worth it to have moved on from him earlier, all those types of things. I'm just asking if their reluctance to pay him is at least in some ways justified because he hasn't gotten them anywhere close to over the hump in his time as the starter. That's all. I'm pro Dak Prescott.
Again,
and I am pro,
I don't want to put words,
keeping the cap number low if you can. So paying him and guaranteeing him
that,
money.
Jason, you do that by signing guys early.
Too long,
you don't do
right.
it by forcing them to get tagged. Once they tag you, that's when you say, blank you.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to force me to do this? Well, then I'm going to make you pay. And do you want that relationship with your quarterback?
No, and
Most good organizations don't.
Right.
They didn't believe in Dak to the point that Dak wanted to be the highest paid guy. They never felt that he validated that. But I guarantee you, they're not looking back saying, we should have never paid Dak Prescott anything. No.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that.
It's kind of what you said. You said they never won a championship. Was it worth it? That's like
they never even
the
got to an
said.
NFC Championship game, though.
So do you believe it was worth it?
Yes, because you don't want to be the teams that are wandering in the wilderness. So that's the
but
cost
you didn't
of
even
doing
get to
business.
A divisional,
I'm just saying
you didn't even
that
get
they're
to an NFC Championship.
No, you are putting words in my mouth, which now Dennis
but
and Plover's going to be upset.
Said, or am
no,
I crazy?
No, what I'm saying is their reluctance? Is there we're never really quite sure about them? Is there some validity to them feeling that way? That's what I'm saying.
No. Yeah, I understand that, but no. Had they done right by Dak with a year left on his deal, coaches and quarterbacks don't get to free agency.
And right now
not
they're
the ones
in both.
You love.
They've got that with
Jason,
their coach and
the
their
ones,
quarterback.
Not the ones you love and you really want. I don't think they care if Mike McCarthy's the coach after this year. I don't think they care. And I don't know if they
Doesn't
really
that mean
care.
They don't
I
care
think
about
Dak,
Prescott either. Now it's just
get to that. His cap hit, if they don't re-sign him, is such a monster next year because they didn't take care of him on the front end. They were forced, fingernail or whatever nails you want to use. They were forced across the line to do it, and now Dak, he does not feel like we're all in this together. He feels like a mercenary. And when you feel mercenary, you hold out until you squeeze every last quarter out of the victim's pocket. That's where they're at. That is not where Russ Ball and the Packers want. That's not what's going to happen. And I think they're going to have to get to that low 50s to make that hole in order to have Jordan feel good about where he's at. Because guess what? Even if he signs for 52, which is what I'm recommending or I'm hoping, guess what? In 4 years, when it's year he signs a 5 or 6 year deal, he'll be 10th or 11th on the list because leapfrog, 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 leapfrog. That's what happens. Leapfrog.
That's going to be a gif. Tell us about Coors Light again, would you?
Coors Light brewed with a 3-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and cold packaged so it's made to chill and make sure those mountains are blue. That's when you know Coors Light's cold activated bottles and cans are chilled to perfection. That's why it is Coors Light in my hand when I need a moment to chill. Celebrate responsibly, Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
Whoa, Nelly is next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
This is Wildy and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
I love playing sports, especially for my school. And that's because school sports are special. It's where it's safe to fail. It's where we're taught resilience, where our fear becomes confidence. It's where we learn to get back up after every fall. School sports are where 7.8 million students go from I can't to I can.
This message presented by the WIAA and the Wisconsin Athletic Directors Association.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy.
We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers. With positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
The madness is back, and so is your chance at proving your hoops knowledge. It's the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge, presented by Cousin Subs. Fill out a bracket, earn the most points at the end of the tourney, and get a $1,000 gift card to Cousin Subs. Fill out your bracket on ESPN.com or the ESPN Tournament Challenge app. Just search ESPN Wisconsin and enter the password Cousins. It's the ESPN Wisconsin Bracket Challenge, presented by Cousin Subs. They believe in better. Visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com for full rules and details.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Get your team together. Softball is back for 2024. Jesse Nelson here. Registration for Madison School and Community Recreation's Adult Summer Softball Leagues is now open. Men's, women's, and all-gender slow pitch and women's fast pitch leagues are forming now for the summer season. MSCR Softball Leagues offer fun for every level of player and welcome all participants. Spend your summer evenings with us on the diamond. For more information and to register, go to MSCRSportsLeagues.org. That's MSCRSportsLeagues.org.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Time now for yet another abbreviated
Whoa, Nelly.
If the topic is good, the guys discuss.
Just the other morning, I had breakfast at Tracy Siraka's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I gotta stay hungry for the Crimson Tide.
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for
Whoa, Nelly
on Wildy and Tausch.
Oops. We have Blake's like camera up on the video stream. All right, we'll fix it. Hey, guys.
Empty seat.
Happy opening day.
Opening day of what?
At 5:05 a.m. tomorrow morning, the Los Angeles Dodgers and the San Diego Padres play the first regular season game of the 2024 MLB season in Seoul, South Korea. It is not in Brazil. Seoul, South Korea. It'll be on ESPN. Sunday Night Baseball crew calling the game. 5 a.m. first pitch.
How long is that flight to Seoul?
Probably similar to your Tokyo trip back in when you made that
time. I love it. Yeah, I think it's great. Obviously, you know, the baseball is huge over in that region, and you're starting to see more and more players develop from that spot, and you want to give them a taste. So I'm all on board, even though I remember it back in the old days. All the Cincinnati Reds have to be the opening game and all this other stuff. Now, it's over, man. Those days are over. And you're doing this. You're giving a little buffer for them to come back, to reset. So I know the purists will hate it. Tough luck. I think it's great.
Wait, the Cincinnati Reds used to always be the first game of the baseball season?
They used to do a parade because they were the first team. So they would always do a parade in Cincinnati, and then they would get first pitch before everybody else.
Wow. I didn't know that. I learned something new during Whoa Nelly.
Whoa Nelly!
Jason, you tuning in for the 5 a.m. baseball game each of the next two days?
And does that conflict with pickleball for Tausch? So he's not watching.
Tausch, unsportsmanlike. I've become a big unsportsmanlike fan, too.
So wait, are you not playing pickleball? Are you currently sidelined? We've heard about your knee.
I'm not playing as much. Having some issues, yeah.
Oh, no.
So, yeah, it's been a little more limited than...
Bone on bone?
Still getting some games in, but just more limited than I would like.
Well, Homer says you can play it in a chair. That's not true, of course. Next.
No, you can. You're not going to be very good, but yeah, you can. You have to have wheels on it.
Wheelchair pickleball?
Well, you can't stand up at the kitchen line if you're not. Like, you have to back up.
Gotta be able to go back and forth, yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa, Nelly!
I went to the dentist yesterday. Great experience. No cavities. Teeth are clean. Why do they try to talk to you when you're sitting in the chair? Like they're
friendliness.
Like and very friendly group at the dentist group that I go to. Very friendly people. Hygienist is great. Dentist is great. They're all great. But when they've got your mouth pried open and they're doing the cleaning and the rinse, they're like asking you a question. Like, why do you do that?
Just mumble.
But do you want me to right away say, or do you want me to wait until you're done and rinse it out and then answer the question? Like. 30 seconds later?
That's a good question, Jesse.
Both fair questions.
I don't know. They shouldn't. I think you don't want to be a rude jerk star. I think what you should do is you say hi, you talk a little bit. Once there's a utensil in said person's hand, it's a wrap.
Then what are you going to do when they talk to you then? Because that's Jesse's question. I agree with your policy, but if they ask you a question, you're just going to ignore them?
Yeah, just say, I'll talk to you after.
But you can't even say that because they got stuff in your mouth.
Yeah, I said what I said. I don't know what else you want me to say. I said what I said. Y'all figure it out on your end.
This is what he's going to say to the hygienist, too. Hey, I said what I said. I'm done.
Yeah.
Whoa, Nelly!
I don't think it's that difficult. I think you can carry on the conversations and... There's, you know, she's a professional. She can probably make out what you said, even though you're not quite as eloquent as you are on the radio. That would be my take.
Fair enough.
Were you happy with how that
went? By the way, they don't want to talk to you either.
Well,
like they don't.
Yeah, it's kind of a one-sided conversation. They want to be rude. Like this dentist, it's nice. They've got TVs that are on. You can watch. Like they had Friends reruns on while I was sitting there. You could watch Joey and the crew.
If you polled dental hygienists, do you want to talk to these schlubs that come and sit in your chair? I got a first off, they got a mask on. And they're dealing with all kinds of, you know, drills and brushes and everything else. They don't want to talk to you. And if you just give them the out, say, hey, man, we're good here. Clean my teeth. I'll thank you. You're going to be paid. And we're all going to go about our business. 80% would say thank you. Thank you.
We have to have dental hygienists who listen to the show. There's probably a dental office or two that has us on somewhere in America. I'd be curious to know if you're right about this. We've got one segment left of the show.
Well, they can't call in from the office and say they don't want to talk to people. Maybe they're call off the next today. Person in.
Maybe they're off today. You will grant you anonymity if you are a dental hygienist, not. And I don't want dental hygienist Chad t- texting and he's a hygienist.
Just so I'm being clear about my point, I think they want to say hello. I think they want to be friendly before that.
Yes.
Before when you sit in the chair, they'll talk. Oh, medications, all this other stuff. All that's great. Once they put the mask on and grab the utensil, they don't want to talk to you as much as Jesse didn't want to talk to them.
Then why is there a conversation happening?
Because people feel like they have to. Yes. You think she really cares about your turtles in your backyard?
Oh, we were talking about the
they
dog.
Don't.
She actually.
Or your bracket. You think Frankie is going to sit there and say, "Hey, Jesse, how's your bracket doing?"
It actually.
They're not.
It started with.
They don't care.
A few days after I was last in, she said she had caught me calling a football game on our ESPN Wisconsin Prep Mania coverage. So we
fan of Jesse's work.
She was asking how the dog was, asking how the house is.
How was the state bowling championship?
Talked about March Madness.
How's Irick? Ira, get a good rate for you on that mortgage.
844-770-3776. We're almost out of show, so text, don't call. 844-770-3776. If you actually are a dental hygienist, how do you view the obligation of conversation? Scuba Chad, Hygienist Chad, don't bother. We'll wrap things up. After I tell you, this is really exciting. Are you going to this, Jesse?
I will not be able to be there, and I'm super bummed that it falls when I'm out of town. I'm really bummed I can't be there.
It's Friday. Finalysis Live. We're doing it. The Antetokounmpo brothers are holding a candid and unscripted conversation on stage in front of a live audience at Pottawatomie Hotel and Casino in Milwaukee. This is part of our Bucks Plus package. Be there for this exclusive evening to discover who Giannis and Thanasis are off the court as they share hilarious and heartwarming stories and find out which special guests may join them as well. Don't miss the chance to explore the Antetokounmpo's pop-up shop on site. Just reading what it says here, man.
The pop-up shop, Antetokounmpo's.
What a pop-up shop.
You try saying it, Tausch.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Featuring exclusive merch available for purchase. All ages are welcome. Doors open at 6 p.m. The event starts at 7 p.m. at Pottawatomie Hotel and Casino. We'll wrap things up next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Jesse Nelson here. Summer is coming, which means it's time to start thinking about a summer job for many of you. Madison School and Community Recreation is now hiring for many positions, including day camp and youth program leaders, outdoor adventure staff, support staff for individuals with disabilities, sports instructors and officials, and more. I was an official for a long time when I was growing up, but even into college and outside of it, it is so much fun, and there's so many life skills that you can take that transfer over into your everyday practice that I do every day. Still today, it's awesome. Great opportunities. Full and part-time positions with daytime and evening hours are available. So no matter your interest, schedule, or location, there's a position for everyone. At MSCR, you can make an immediate impact in the community and gain meaningful experience. Start your summer adventure today. Apply online at MSCR.org.
Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at greatdanepub.com. For the 15th time in program history, the Wisconsin women's hockey team is headed to the Frozen Four. With a 4-0 win over St. Lawrence at LeBon on Saturday, the reigning national champion Badgers have the opportunity to defend their crown this weekend in Durham, New Hampshire. Wisconsin will face off with Colgate in the Frozen Four, with the winner headed to the national championship game on Sunday. Clarkson and conference foe Ohio State will face off in the other semifinal. Puck drop between Colgate and Wisconsin set for 6:30 this Friday on ESPN+.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to prairieathletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown here from ESPN Madison. For the best Southwestern food and margaritas in the Madison area, it's always Pascual's Cantina for me. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pascual's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Plus, they have one of the largest tequila selections around. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at pasquale'scantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pascual's Cantina.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
What does it take to make a diamond? Extreme heat and pressure and about a billion years. But you can't wait that long. What do? You go to Goodman's Jewelers. I'm John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. There's a reason we are the diamond store of Madison. Since 1933, we provided outstanding service and selection to our customers. And that in turn has helped to establish countless great memories through the years. Goodmansjewelers.com, located at 220 State Street. Truly a destination worth reaching.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
We're on the tournament.
I think I'm ready to say the Badgers are fully back.
Because we're on Wisconsin Sports.
You want to be playing your best ball in March, and Greg Gard has this group doing just that.
This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Jesse, you got two texts from the dental hygienist of our fan base?
Oh, no, it didn't update. Shoot, okay, I'm just going to have to read it. So we have one here from Eric in Green Bay. Some dentist hygienists definitely want to chat. My wife and I lived out in Michigan for a few years while she's in residency. My dentist was a University of Michigan season football ticket holder. He wrote a book on fantasy football. He would wave off the hygienist in order to talk sports every time that I came in.
I get that at my dentist, too.
Ben in Madison, I used to be an assistant in oral surgery, and we put our patients to sleep, and trust me, we'd much rather have it that way.
Dang. That's a little more cold-blooded than a guy would like.
Stronger than Tausch's position, even.
I just don't think. I think they want to talk for a certain period. Then they want to do their job and move on with their life. That's what I think.
Well, we did our job today.
If Cindy Crawford comes in, you're probably interested in talking to her. If Sidney Johnson comes in, you're probably not as intrigued.
Cindy Crawford is not coming to our dentist. Not after the way our interview went in 2016. That's it for us today. We will do it again tomorrow. Thanks for coming along for the ride. Have a great day. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free, full show.